As welcome as a porcupine at a nudist colony.
We are recording. This is session, I think, 8.
Session 8, that's correct.
This is session 8 of ETU. Last week, our illustrious college students were recruited by Cochise's, Johnny Moon's girlfriend.
Illustrious, but not all of the ones we met were luscious.
To look into issues with her roommate, who had been spending a little too much time at Alpha Phi.
The
boys infiltrated Alpha Phi, some in different manner than others.
Well, Mikey infiltrated Alpha Phi already.
Joe Diffie did score one with the Alpha Phi.
With enthusiastic consent for anybody who's on college campus.
Way to go, Joe Diffie. You guys drank two more under the table, scouted out the house, eventually located a trapdoor in the pantry.
Yes, we did.
Where does that trapdoor go?
Opening the trapdoor in the pantry, the distinct smell of burnt wood fills your nostrils. It's strong, much more than a typical campfire. A ladder leads down into the darkness.
Well, if there's any big Ramones fans right now, you can cue the music for I Don't Want to Go Down to the Basement.
We should have already
nobody ever listens to the Ramones.
So,
nope.
We have flashlights. Check phones.
Cell phone.
Oh, yeah. Modern. Edison is drunk.
Edison has been indulging in what would be considered excessive alcohol.
Yeah.
Heavy libation.
He doesn't drink alcohol, really, ever.
Well, after the federal court case. Oh, we don't know about that.
I don't know. Do you? Maybe at some point.
It depends on how often you've gotten drunk.
Did we? We made it down, didn't we, to this arena?
This is the basement. We're in this
place. I showed you the basement. You never went to the basement.
Oh, maybe not.
I'm changing it. We were in the pantry. You were in the pantry with the adjustable wrench.
With the wrench.
You opened the trap door, which was under something, and that's where we wrapped up.
And our mission was to help the girlfriend of Johnny Moon figure out what was the deal with her roommate.
Yes.
Acting weird and very protective around the.
And when she went to go check on the sorority would.
Bonnie Elliott was in trouble.
Right.
Which, if you think about it, that's typical rush behavior.
That's anybody.
She's out of it. She's not really, you know, she's kind of glassy eyed. Sneak deprived. She's going to the sorority house all the time. The sorority is being very secretive.
Call the cops.
Yeah.
Clearly.
Yeah. Or she's rushing a sorority and stay the hell out of the way.
You know, it strikes me, the best place to be a cop, ETU.
You have no responsibilities whatsoever.
You never have to follow up on missing persons.
Sorry, ma'am, I didn't check your drawers.
Yeah,
it's just a needler.
Anyway.
If I was a psychopath and I had a predilection for killing people, that's where I would go.
All right, who's headed down? Who's headed down first? And what should we take? Kitchen knives?
Well, we get that train back on.
Should we take some weapons, knives from the kitchen?
Yes. I take a mixing bowl and a spatula.
What's that a way to say? I love you.
I thought it was a classic skillet. Isn't
that? No, we don't have any women at our party. No butts of barbed.
I'm using it as a helmet.
The pot?
The pot of the helmet.
Johnny Moon earned a Benny for the mixing bowl as a helmet. It's plastic.
guys, there's more of that juice.
A meat tenderizer.
There you go.
Can I find one of those? Like,
it's got little spikes on it. It's a bowl.
Sure. Johnny Moon finds... Well, give me a notice check. What, is anybody else looking for anything?
I'm looking for oil, cooking oil, matches, and a lighter.
Okay.
Matches hit the
fire. I will tell you the cooking
oil. Are you
going
to use a lighter to light the matches?
Cooking oil doesn't burn.
I burn it. My wife's burnt it. Okay. Well,
not
two.
Not at the temperatures you get to.
You don't find a hammer.
I'll just take it right.
Have you ever watched Mythbusters?
Yeah, but we're heading
out. There's some great stuff in cooking oil.
Yeah, but you got to get it for like 500 degrees.
Yeah, to keep that, let's see.
I mean, they're a kitchen, so within reason, Johnny Moon could not find the meat tenderizer.
Is there a rolling pin?
What about a baking baster?
Oh, yeah.
It's a sorority. They make cookies all the time.
Turkey baster?
Yeah, the turkey baster's in somebody's room.
That's right.
Yes, you find your rolling pin.
Knife.
Of course, you are an idiot how weakling, so you're trying not to bang yourself in the face with it when you hold it up.
How about a drunk meat cleaver? Meat cleaver, because they chop.
I couldn't find the... Oh, the cleaver. Okay.
Meat cleaver.
Give me a notice, sir, for that one.
Okay.
One little is wondering why the hell you guys are wasting so much
time. You find a meat cleaver.
I got a meat cleaver, boys. What kind? Is it against
the butcher.
Oh.
Yeah.
The bench. No, it's a candlestick maker.
Edison has the MacGyver edge. Maybe now would be a good time for a montage to build something useful as we go downstairs.
He might be able to build a crossbow
out of rolled paper.
How about a light source?
Phones. Okay.
I thought we have the spell. Can we do that?
You don't have the spell.
The ritual?
Yeah, we have
a ritual. Okay.
Nobody's taken that ritual yet.
Our cell phones don't put out light anymore? No,
they do, but mine actually turns off after a couple of minutes. It doesn't like that. It doesn't want to throw out the LED.
Yours doesn't?
Is there hard liquor around?
Okay, do LEDs get hot enough to burn out?
Some of it.
All right, I'm going to take a couple bottles of hard liquor. I'm going to shove some towels in there. A little light, a little Molotov if we need to.
Yeah, you got two of those.
I say it works as a torch and a Molotov cocktail.
And we can drink it if anything else fails.
Party time. And even to disinfect it.
It's
a disinfectant.
It's a
disinfectant.
You want pencil or pen?
Pencil.
You got it.
Pick one, Bob. Joe Jeffy, you improvising anything?
Just my charm.
So you're going last, huh?
Edison, what are you doing? If you want to try to improvise something, you're welcome to. You already have a negative for your...
MacGyver, man.
I think Edison is going to find various alcohols to try to make the perfect wrench. That's how he's going to use his MacGyver, because he's already altered mentally.
We should make some coffee over here.
He's going to go.
He's going to try to make the perfect wrench.
All right, so give me a MacGyver there.
No. Before we go downstairs, we need to brew a cup of coffee.
There's a Keurig there with a little cup of
Edison,
is it?
Blowing
we water. Make one.
He rolls a five. Minus one because he's drunk, I think.
Sure. Edison comes up with something that he considers exceptional.
Nice. I promptly drink it.
Give me a bigger check at minus one.
Okay, his bigger is...
Bigger spirit, your choice.
Edison's drinking more. Throw it out. Edison, do you really want to drink that?
Three.
Well, so that was minus two for all rolls.
Okay.
I give Edison a little cup of coffee. Edison, this has liquor in it. This is called an Irish coffee.
I love you guys.
Ford found the Keurig.
Ah. Filled with water. Damn it. Every time. That's why you gotta get the ones that have a hard line.
This place has 40 people. It has a hard line.
Yeah.
Ooh. Nice.
So.
Cup of coffee.
Another?
Yes.
Okay.
Glass of water. Got a pee?
Yes.
Joe, keep an eye on Edison in the back, will you?
All right, who's going down the ladder first?
One low, Bill.
I'm right behind him.
Okay.
You guys, when you go to the train, it's the train station. When you go on a plane, it's the plane station.
When you play games, it's a PlayStation. You hold the light. I'm going to go first.
Let's tie a rope to him so I didn't have to climb down and just lower it.
I really don't know if we should go down, but I'll leave that to you guys to handle.
All right, so you start climbing down the ladder. It's longer than you would expect. It's almost like you're skipping a whole level.
That's what she said?
Jesus! Ah! Anybody, come on!
I got you.
Just
wait. Let it sit.
See, I never heard that before, so I didn't get it.
I've never once used that. I've never once heard that.
Joe Diffie, where are you in the marching order here?
I'm moved to back with Edison.
Okay.
He's taking up the rear? Oh, boy.
And where are you?
I'll be before Edison, after these guys.
Okay, so it is
one
low.
Two.
Joe
Diffie.
Joe Diffie. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so you head down. You probably go down a good 15, 20 feet. And it's just like empty space. You don't. It's dark. Your light doesn't show anywhere, anything specific. You pass through.
Yeah.
And end up in a...
It's a little puny light.
Actually, this light's pretty strong.
Yeah.
Start wearing both.
But thank you for shining it in my eyes. Minus one Benny for you.
Jeff, give him a Benny.
Harsh.
Thanks.
Oh, my God. They're
firing. Oh, by the way, lasers are light waves, not sound waves.
Jules got that wrong, too, if it makes you feel better.
You know, that's okay with 11-year-old getting that wrong.
All right, so you guys make it down. You come into what looks like a burned-out shell of a room. There were a couple beds in there. All charcoal. The stench is you know, totally burned out. It's dark other than your lights.
What is it with this town on fire?
It's an easy way to destroy things.
Oh, that's right. This house was on fire.
The previous house had burned down.
Oh, sorry, I wasn't listening at all. I was playing with this.
What?
What did you say when we got down on the bottom?
You came out in a...
No, really.
I'm
getting back.
All right, Dick.
You came out in a bedroom. Well, with the remains of a bedroom.
Boy. What's the...
Is it getting quiet up here?
All right, let's take a look around.
A bedroom?
Yes. It looks like it belonged to a girl based on what's laid out in there.
The fact that it's a sorority house.
Pretty charred.
it's charred, but I mean, there's still remnants and stuff, you know, there's a frilly little thing that might have been part of her cover.
What was the name of the girl who got burnt in the...
Nobody was killed.
I just don't know.
Oh.
Nina.
Hartley? Nina Hartley?
Yeah. Yeah, this burned down only a couple years ago. Nina's from a long earlier.
Jeff, you don't know Nina Hartley? You don't know.
Is there a door out? Does it look like there's an exit from where we are?
Yes, I'm actually going to
load it up.
I've seen some structural
issues. I just want to escape route when, you know, zombies come. Oops.
So just to set the mode. All right, you guys are killing me. We're going to get nothing done here.
Well, I was talking about Nina Hartley over here, not realizing who she is. All
right, so if you'll scroll.
Just come up with another random name. Sasha Gray. I don't know.
That one I don't know.
So just to.
Well, Nina Hartley's like pretty old, so at least from the 80s. Okay. So I know the vintage.
So if you guys will scroll up a little bit, you can see some of the burned out rooms here. You just kind of set the mood a little bit.
Oh, that's a good one.
The place is a disaster. The floor's questionable in places.
The floor should just be concrete down here.
And the construction.
I wonder why they didn't rebuild this.
This is two stories down, though.
I wonder why they didn't rebuild this.
Yeah,
20
feet.
Yeah. Do we go back in time? Check your watch. What time is it? What's the date here?
Should I be here tomorrow?
Is this a violation of building code?
No, we're fine. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Don't touch anything, though.
Right.
Don't collapse.
You ever see that movie where they hear the noise and they go down in the basement? And then good things happen to them, and then they win the lottery. You ever
those
see that girls movie?
They find.
No, I never see that movie.
That's because that never happens to anybody. Never happens to anybody, Wallo. Let's get out of here.
I didn't see that movie either. Come on, let's go.
Okay.
All right, so you come down. You're what's listed as BR1 on the map.
Wait, hold on. I
should look around and see if we see any footprints or anything underground.
There's two windows. They're broken. It almost looks like the building has slid underground somewhat because it's completely black out there.
Hey, look, we're at Star Trek. Lens flare.
And the room is full of just ash and char. So the floor spots, there's questionable spots in the floor.
Are there footprints in the ash and char?
There's not dust. It's just rubbish all over. So, yeah, people could walk through it. It's hard
but,
to tell.
I mean, if there's ash.
Well, then you would have to notice it.
Oh, all right. Let's
do a notice as well. What you're looking for, ash.
Looking for signs of life.
My name is Ash.
Do you know that they are doing a Ash versus the Evil Dead?
Well, you gotta know.
Really?
You see what
yeah,
you find
it's
going to
be airing this this September. It's going to be six
show?
Episodes.
Yeah, you didn't know that?
No.
Come on, even I knew that.
Is it going to be with
yes.
Bruce Campbell?
It is.
I'm so on that.
I know.
All right, so what do we got for our notice checks?
That's the second
Bruce
spoiler.
Seven.
Edison looks down and he sees two of everything.
Does Edison vomit when he does that?
He just got a three.
Okay,
minus two.
Failure.
No critical.
So as Edison almost is actually he's bending down and he keeps going down way too far, so Juan Lo has to grab him and keep him from falling over and is thus unable to search around him.
Thank you. Thank you, Juan Lo.
Joe Diffie?
Just take it easy. Just
kind of. Yeah, seven.
You got a seven? Okay.
You're the best.
So we got a search. You four are... got a seven. Johnny Moon got a six and Joe Diffie got a seven. Looking around, it is obvious that there's been some disturbance in this room. There's a slight path that heads through. You can hear some creaking, other noises further into the structure.
Sorry, guys, that was me. Sorry about that.
No, it wasn't like a gas. Creaky crap.
Now, can we see straight through the walls, or is it kind of it's half and half? Like,
it's half and half.
It's hard to see.
It's hard to see. Like I said, there's you can tell there's weak spots in the floor, so there's probably a floor below you. If you want to try to look down there, you might see something. Mattress that's half charred. There's another one that's almost completely gone. There's a closet with, you know, a couple hangers left, no clothes.
Oh, no clothes.
Desk.
Oh.
Typical sorority room.
It does what it's told.
Except
if it was
after fires.
Yeah. All right, we will gingerly watching for weak spots on the floor and going around them. We'll just watch them and walk through them. Head for the door and look out into the next room or hallway or what have you.
I'm looking for any identifiable
fingernail
names,
scratches,
pictures, photographs, papers.
Yeah, most of the papers are.
I assume most is burnt just
yeah.
because of the.
So it should be easy to identify anything that is still legible.
And. Hold on a second while I try to build this.
One low, we should set a booby trap.
Booby traps?
That's what I said.
Slick shoes. Guys, I got an idea. Slick shoes.
Slick shoes. Slick shoes? Are you crazy?
All right, so you enter through a hall. It looks like you're in a corner room. The hallway goes both straight ahead and to the right.
I'll go first. Boing. Sorry.
Why? You've been off topic all night. Why start now?
Oh, where's this negativity coming from?
Trying to make it look good. We're still in the hall. We can go to. All right, so we're heading out. We can go to right,
or straight ahead,
or left.
Right.
Let's head to the left.
Or we could also explore the floorboards and see if we can get a peek into what's beneath us.
Probably creatures from the, you know, bad things.
Wouldn't it be nice to know what's there before we get there?
Is there any cracks or creaks in that we can peek through, perhaps?
Back in the bedroom, there's some spots on the floor that it's kind of burned through, but it's completely black down there.
Yeah.
You know, it'd be hard to get a light and your face in.
Guys, you could lower me down. I'm totally. You remember we did that with the sacrificial altar? I could do that.
You hear a creak. You hear a creak out in the hall, almost like somebody's moving out there.
Oh, nice.
Did you all hear that?
I try to peek out, hiding our lights.
So you try to look out into the black.
So you look out. It's dark.
I have the infrared.
I don't know. Maybe it wasn't.
You have low light vision.
That's gonna come in handy. Tell you.
Because, you know, low light vision always works.
That's the best thing.
Do I see anything?
It's dark.
Nobody has infrared on this?
Oh. Hey, wait.
Guys, it's dark.
Do I have my camera stuff?
You're whispering.
No, I didn't say that.
You have a cell phone light. I mean, I'm giving you a flashlight. I don't have a problem. That's completely acceptable.
Shine light down the hallway.
That's really amazing. So we shine light down the hallway?
Sure.
Wait a second. Wait to see if we hear anything else.
Everybody has a cell phone on? Why don't we take one cell phone and we slide it down the hallway all the way down with the light up?
I think everything down here has heard Edison. I'm not giving you my cell phone. I'm at level 52 at Candy Crush. It took me a long time to get there. I'm not losing my cell phone.
You're bad at that
game. Yeah. You just started. That takes like 7 minutes.
I've been playing for like 3 years. What are you talking about?
Okay, that's fine.
Should we duck back into the bedroom?
It's been a long time. Agility D4.
$700 later. I'm just level
53.
Yeah, there's no focus tonight at all.
Should we back out to the bedroom again?
We're
right
in the bedroom, kind of looking around the corner. So it's a little closet on the left-hand side there.
We're here?
The door. You're looking out into the hallway.
All right. We look, listen, and feel.
I like to feel
we should set somebody up towards the ladder, so when they first walk in, they see somebody at the ladder. And then have somebody behind the door, so they're focused on that. And then if they come through, we can go that way.
Edison, go hang out on the ladder.
Edison, hang out on the bed.
Where's the
bed? Do we feel like here, see anything coming towards us?
You think you might hear a little motion out there?
Could be rats.
Something scampering around, but it doesn't sound a lot big enough to be human.
Does it appear to be like wet, damp down here, or is it dry?
There's definitely some damp.
Basement damp or fire hose damp?
Hard to tell. But you know, it's like when you pour water on a fire; it just doesn't smell good ever again.
Oh yeah.
All right, maybe we put the folks on a low setting.
I might have stroke.
What's under the floor? Did we look under the floorboards yet?
I think we tried.
Oh.
We thought about it, Edson.
Oh. All right.
We gave it two shakes to land, so.
Why don't you get on the floor and work on that, Edison?
Why is the whole room, moving? Did they put, some sort of device in here?
You go first. No, you go first.
Right, can we go
put
out
the phone up to
ball,
Edison right underneath his
nose? I don't know what's going on.
Joey Diffie, what are you doing?
I'm scared.
Joey Diff, come on.
I'm just getting impatient and just saying, come on, let's just move down the hall. What's the difference?
All right,
Joe Diffie, you come with me.
I'm going to go, guys, I'm going to go up to that corner. Somebody follow me and come around the corner if I don't stop you.
Okay. Give us the...
We'll have to work tomorrow. All right.
You come up unless I stop you.
Yeah.
Right, okay. You get to the corner. When you get to the corner, I'll move up.
I'll take the mirror.
I go up to the corner. Almost blind. We have a little bit of light coming from the bedroom.
Uh-huh.
But I get up to the corner, and I try to look, listen, and feel.
I get Edison.
Show me what you mean by the corner. Okay. So it's I'm not going to reveal much more because you really don't see much more. You're in a corner of a hallway. There's numerous doors leading off. You suspect you're probably, they're probably all bedrooms, for the most part bedrooms.
I said
hallway.
Look up here.
All right.
Look up here.
And everybody else closes the door and goes back up the, No, I'm just kidding. Is anybody gonna?
Yes, we finally found.
Wamo will go. He'll go down around the corner.
Seems like a bad Scooby-Doo episode.
Somebody go this way.
I'll go to the other corner. Just
this
stand.
Way.
Yeah.
All right, Wamo goes this way.
All right, where is it? So, is some of you were in the bedroom, some of you in the hallway. What's
yeah,
the...
we're coming out single file kind of thing.
All right,
pretend like we're ninjas or SWAT people.
Yeah, I have my butter knife.
All right. So I'm going to reveal some more, and at this point, I'm going to say everybody is somewhere in the hallway.
With the revolver.
There's no revolver.
Oh. So David doesn't have his revolver?
No, he said he left that at home.
What did he take from the kitchen? Diff, what did you take from the kitchen?
The lead pipe, the wrench, candlestick?
I took the candlestick.
Kitchen knife?
He took his awesome substance.
Oh, that's all you need. His sharp wit.
Out of, you can't see my mouth. Bob, how do I make it show but not go somewhere? I got it.
Have you got it?
I think so. I think I can do it.
Because of ventilation.
Okay, so out of that doorway.
Well done, you pinged successfully.
Out of that doorway.
It's a bathroom.
A teddy bear walks. Think Ted. Except it's white. It's like a polar bear. Okay. And it's got burns all over it.
Is singing Teddy Bears Have Their Picnic?
It's like the saddest thing you've ever seen. It kind of hobbles a little bit.
Oh, stop it.
But it's
Let it
walking.
Be. Let it be.
And it comes up to Juan Lowe, I guess, is the closest.
That's in the front, yeah.
And it reaches up to you.
Oh,
like, it wants you to pick it up and give it a hug.
You should.
No fucking way.
I'm getting this on video. I'm recording this, by the way.
It's the saddest thing I've ever seen.
It's the creepiest freaking thing I've ever seen. Are you nuts?
What do you got, Joe Diffie?
Can I attempt to talk to it?
You don't attempt.
You're going to walk over there and see what it's up to?
I have that edge now. I want to try it sometime.
The psychic linkage or whatever it is?
Sure. Psychically sensitive.
Sure. Okay, so you walk over to it. It's only, 2 feet tall. Do you kneel down or anything?
Yes, I kneel down a little bit.
I attempt to grab him as he kneels down and not let him get, his face near that fucking thing.
And it reaches out to you for a hug. You can feel like there's something there.
I feel like there's something there?
Yeah, you don't know what, it's new to you. Actually, give me a check on your skill.
Hey, Joe, you should try waka waka waka. It may work. May get something.
What exactly is the role that I'm supposed to make for this?
You should have the skill or an edge or something.
Plus two rolls to sense or communicate with supernatural beings.
There's anything freaking natural about this being. It's a freaking walking teddy bear, man.
You ever had it before? Chucky, Ted.
I don't think you get more supernatural than a walking teddy bear.
Guys, I gotta tell you, when I was 8 years old, I had a Rumpelstiltskin, and I was in my bedroom, and it was in the corner, and one night, its little Teddy Ruxpin head just kind of spun and looked at me from the corner. It was horrible.
I had a Rumpelstiltskin.
So it's reaching out for you, Mikey, like it wants to give you a hug. He's looking for a hug. It's sad.
Oh, Mikey, I got your back.
Looking at his face, based on the burns, you feel bad for it.
Edison,
ready my action. I have my knife and I'm ready, and I say, Mikey, pick it up. And I'm ready to jut in and cut its head off if need be.
And stab Mikey in the throat.
You can't kill it.
Edison is so overcome.
Little guy, you need a hug.
He gets down on his hands and knees.
I'm pushing Edison back.
And he gives the teddy bear a great big hug.
You should give him a hug.
Wait, Edison, Joe Diffie was there first. Joe, did you take the hug first?
I'll give him a hug based on Cochise.
I'm ready.
Apologies.
Okay, and the teddy bear comes over to you. Adams.
No good can come of it.
It's a freaking walking teddy bear. Oh, my God. You guys are freaked out about this. Really? Everybody thinks this is okay?
Compared to the other shit that we've dealt with, this is like the least thing to worry about.
They were going to be okay here. It hobbles over to Mikey and to Joe Diffie. And Gid puts its arms around him.
Yes.
And before you know what's happening, Joe, it's strangling you.
It's got its
arms around you.
But it can't get enough stuffing around you to do anything.
That's a bad touch.
It's the cutest way.
You're so cute.
It was like Ted size. Its arms will get around the neck.
I go to activate my plans.
Head off.
Otis activates his plan.
Decapitation.
Decapitation. Give me a fighting roll.
You don't get too close to Diffy.
I was gonna say,
it has an Alpha Phi symbol.
Five.
It's like
you knocked the stuffing apple.
You kick the stuffing. Kochi swings in, grabs the head, decapitates it. It doesn't let go. The door you guys came in slams shut. You hear more motion.
More.
I try to deal the cards.
Actually, it should be able to slip over his head.
Could this be the TPK by Teddy Bear?
TK.
So we have to skip Joel unless somebody gets two cards.
Mr. Two.
Are you quick these days or something?
I've changed anything. No, I'm a zebra.
You're a zebra. Okay, so no extra cards.
And how many cards did you do?
The DM one, just one. Okay.
So we have running in first in reverse alphabetical. We have two jacks dealt. This jack of spades.
Not Joker, Jack.
Jack of spades to Johnny Moon. And then Edison has got the jack of hearts. And then we have a tie for second place with two sixes.
Spades and hearts again.
Yep. And Joe Diffie will go third with a six of spades. And Juan Lo will go fourth with a six of hearts. And then the bad guy will go. And then, what did you guys
name? Ford.
Ford prefix. Brings up the rear
hearts.
Damn it.
All right, so it is. Who's up first then?
That's going to be Bob.
It's going to be Bob.
No, no, reverse alphabetical.
Oh, Jeff.
It's Jeff.
All right, so Johnny Moon, the teddy bear.
Tears rush in. Where the angels dare to tread.
The teddy bear is clamped onto Joe Dippy's throat. Joe Dippy's like, I'm going to die from a fucking teddy bear?
That head came off easy. You know what else is going to come off?
I cut off one of its arms.
Tail. Those arms.
No tail. I'm going
to cut those arms off. Fighting attack, I assume, is the same kind of attack.
Five. Leaps in there, pulls back enough to get in there, lops the arm off.
Sure,
what
scissors?
Releasing the hole.
I chuck it.
Throw it against the wall. Falls down.
Does it come crawling after us
with
its one
awesome.
Arm?
Yes.
So the arm is now crawling back after us?
No,
the
decapitated arm hits the ground.
Do we have to deal another
Johnny Moon threw the rest of the bear against the wall. It slumped down, then it kind of rolled over and started to crawl back toward you guys.
Arm. Is the hand still in front of us?
Oh, God!
The arm, well, it doesn't really have hand. It's just, you know, it's a bear. Yeah.
Somebody chant a magical spell. Please look at it.
Yes, the face, the head is there, the arm is there.
As our pressure on Synthos. It's not working.
Nothing.
If only I was.
All right, Edison.
You should light it.
Edison is in an altered state. He takes his trusty.
Edison must think this is like.
This is a lot of fun. He starts beating on the arm
this
with a rolling pin.
This party again. Yeah.
He starts beating the arm with the rolling pin.
Yes. Just hitting the arm with the rolling pin.
All right, party roll.
No, wait, like the whole arm or the one that's attached or the one that's detached?
The one that's detached on the ground.
Is that the one that's crawling towards us?
No, the whole body is crawling.
So you're attacking the immobile, the one that is not moving.
Edison is not thinking straight.
I just wanted to make sure you're okay.
Yeah. He has fighting a...
This reminds me of our first good session, where I was taking pictures.
And he gets a double twos, minus two for drunkenness, so a zero.
So Edison slams the rolling pin into...
Oh, boy.
Roll of these things.
Oh, boy.
It's not a critical failure.
I know, that's why it's not going to hurt.
Two.
Into on low.
Ah, what you doing? Why you hit my leg?
I'm just trying to get the teddy bear.
The teddy bear's over there.
The teddy bear's right here, too.
The teddy bear's there. There's stuffing everywhere.
Sorry, it was a slaughter.
Teddy
no,
bear.
No, our slaughter.
Bear.
Sorry, Wanlo.
Joe Diffie.
Yep.
So the teddy bear is through the two legs, the torso, and one arm is crawling back towards you.
Oh, God.
The head is, there's a head in the corner. Off to the side, and there's an arm at your feet.
Is the head able to see us? Like, if it was...
It's sure, it's facing you.
Oh, God.
Why did you do this to me?
Told you not
what
to.
What do you have to do, Joe?
I think I'm going to... So the arm that's on the floor next to me, I kick.
Okay. I'll give you a free action for that one.
And, And then I immediately turn to everybody and say, that's the last time I deal with the teddy bear.
I'm throwing my
The only teddies you're dealing with now are on girls.
Or
the only teddies I'm dealing with are the ones I crumple up and throw in the corner.
The door did slam shut from the bathroom. The bedroom became out of.
Behind us.
Yes.
Which is good. Slam shut is better than open.
Yeah. Well, you can't. Means you can't get back to the ladder.
Large marks.
Large.
Anything else, Joe?
That means I was riding with.
Waiting and seeing.
Her ghost.
You hear more scampering in the background.
Nice. The girls' toys are all.
Do we see any light coming anywhere?
The only light you have is what you brought. Anything else, Joe? Are you good?
I think I'm okay for right now.
Oh, all
right,
so
moving
excited.
On to Wanlo. Wanlo with the big bruise in the back of his calf.
Wanlo, what direction did we hear the? Lights. What direction did we hear the other noises
it's
from?
It's all around.
And we're at the door to a room.
You are right in front of.
Oh wait, which probably isn't a good idea.
This, you're right at this door.
All right, Wanlo shines his light in that room. He turns on his light, looks in the room, and sees.
Scene from the labyrinth.
Oh, so
yes. Yeah.
No, not that way.
Another teddy bear comes racing out. Another teddy bear comes racing out and leaps on Wan Lo.
Can I try to hit it as it's leaping at me?
What jumped on you?
A teddy bear.
See, this is where the rules break down a little bit.
Yeah.
Why don't we do an opposed agility check?
Okay.
Wait, describe this teddy bear.
It looks like Teddy, except it's more of a polar bear. It has an Alpha Phi on it.
Oh, same one?
And it's trying to
fucking kill me. Oh, it's another one.
Me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's trying to fucking kill me.
Yeah. That's
Ted didn't try to kill anybody. Nothing. I gotta see it still. Four.
Three.
Two.
You may act.
So I get to hit. I get to do a fighting attack.
You can attack. You can try to dodge.
I'm just, it's coming at me. Pah!
Pah.
Five.
So your hand hits stuffing?
Nine.
Just kind of bounces off, hits the ground, stands back up.
I would hope that it flew back, actually.
Not far. I mean, really, if I threw a stuffed animal at you and you...
I don't know, do we have a stuffed animal nearby?
Not handy.
Careful, Wan Lo, they're a pack. They travel in packs, they're
hunted.
At least
they don't bite you.
You see, you think you might have saw more motion in the back of the room.
Oh, God.
We shut that door in.
You all set?
Can I shut the door?
No.
Okay.
It opened. It's burned off the hinges.
All right. Well,
nice.
I don't know, just one moment. Like, can I put the light in my shirt pocket and fight with two hands? I'm sure that looked horrible.
Yeah, I really didn't need to see that tonight. All right, Wan Lo done?
I don't think that trying to grab the one that I knocked down and rip its arms off would be a little bit more than another action.
Yes.
Fine code.
So I'm back in the defensive stance. I'm ready for whatever's coming next.
Back against
all right, so on the creature's turn.
Teddy bear. Don't call them creatures. That's insensitive.
Teddy bear.
Oh, it's a creature.
No, two more come out of this room.
Come on.
Oh, I gotta go right. I gotta click the right.
Did they come out of the darkness?
Two more come out of this dark room. Two more come out of this dark room.
We don't know which dark room you're talking about.
Every time there's a break in the shape, there's a door.
So we walked right past two doors and we didn't realize it? Oh, that's because
Well, you would kind of look down there, yeah. And there's a little door here on the bottom right.
It's because I didn't know there was a
fucking
door there.
Oh, yeah. You wouldn't have noticed at that point.
It was dark.
You would have noticed at that point anyway.
There's a door to our right, though, huh?
Yeah, there's at least six more that you can tell, and there's still more motion.
Nice. We should probably not open any of those doors.
They're all open or burned off.
I think we need to go to a defendable spot.
If only we had fire, like something that would be explosive and easy to carry.
Well, it's Chris's turn. Conveniently, it's Ford's turn.
Do you really think we should be blowing things up down here while we're in the basement?
I'm not going to blow anything up.
It's not like I said you smell gas. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
No, that was just one little shit.
Do you want me to light these things so they become hot, hairy fireballs jumping at us?
Yeah. That sounds great.
Onion.
No. Are you sure? Because that would be
really
fun.
I think
this is what you do in Edison.
Oh.
This is what I want you to do.
So six more showed up. The one that was on the ground
is now
reached Joe Diffie.
Oh boy.
Has wrapped both legs and one arm around his leg.
Let's retreat, guys. I yell to everybody, let's move back down the hallway. Where should we go? Down the main hallway?
Are we at the end of the round? Did the teddy bears have their turn?
Most of them came from this direction.
You saw that? Farther down the hallway. To the right.
To the right.
Oh, that way?
They came from down here, down below.
The branch in the hallway.
They came from down here and out of here. So your best option if you're going to try to retreat is to go to the right.
We retreat to the right.
There's a smaller door. There's a smaller
right
door
at the L.
Here.
All right, I'm going to make my way to that door.
And then the other doors go on further.
There's more of a hall.
Yes.
Well, we have to do initiative and act on our turn, right?
Well, he's.
Oh, you guys going to act.
I'm going to scout ahead.
Yeah.
Here, so you can see all the doors now, Adam. How they're slightly.
Okay. Different. They're not doors. They're jars.
All right, I'm going to head down to.
The one on the right, or the one on the bottom, I should say, below the L.
Yeah.
That has a restroom symbol on it.
Does anybody?
Anybody have to hit the head? That's not going to be big enough for us all to fit in.
This is a sorority house.
Oh, it's a sorority. Yeah, yeah, big. Okay, yeah, so is the door open? What can I see? Is it? Because we're right across.
You can kick the door open.
I got to kick it open.
Kick the door open?
Because it can't be stuffed animals in the bathroom, people. There could be other things.
I read like that Myrtle. There are alligators in the sewers that come out at night.
Can I get two of those out?
Into the
pestles. So you kick in, you can see a stall.
Just a
couple.
It's a bigger room. You just don't see it all. You only see it for a second.
Oh.
Right. Well, perfect.
Yeah, you kicked the door. It didn't
come to you, thank God. All right, I take my flashlight, turn it on, slide it on the ground so the light's in the room.
I'll give you some more light for that.
Here we go. I don't care about the screen at this point. I have an out-of-box. I do. I'm smart.
Toilets.
All right, I
urine on the bathroom, guys, just saying.
I yell at everybody to come in the bathroom and to defend the door.
All right, deal them up.
Yeah, here we go. Yeah, there it is. 10 of hearts.
Oh, yeah.
6 of puppy.
3, nice.
3 of hearts. 10 of puppy.
Are there any face cards in that deck?
2
Nobody
hearts.
Got any face cards on the good guy's side. And let's see
and
how the bad guys
ace
are.
Of spades.
Ace of diamonds.
Ace of diamonds.
You're way off.
So the order of operations will be the bad guys first, followed by Juan Lo, then Ford Prefect, then we've got Edison, then Johnny Moon, and then Joe Diffie.
So Joe Diffie, you will note that the bear that's hugging on your leg is absurdly strong. You know, almost like you feel like you're starting to cut off circulation.
And it's doing weird things.
It is not helping his leg. It's not a dog.
All right. Well,
you said it was a creature. He can't decide if he wants to go slide up or slide down. Climb up or slide down.
It's just how he says hi. That's all.
All right, so to recap, Ford is in the bathroom.
Right, holding the door open. But...
Joe Diffie is, I'm going to call it by the first A in Hall, by the first L in Hall,
yep.
With one strapped around his leg. Yeah. Johnny Moon is right next to him. Those two are blocking the hall from further activity. Edison, I'm guessing, is behind them by the A or the H. And Juan Lo, who is in the front, is by the second L hall. Does that make sense to everybody?
Yep.
Yep, sure.
Roll around
the hall. I'm kind of in that doorway to bedroom number 4.
Okay, so a clip from Edison's most bizarre hallucinogenic dream. 6 Alpha Phi teddy bears, slightly worse for wear, burned, eyeball missing, hobble, run, leap, attack, Edison.
Oh, good. Thank God.
Hey, they look really cute. Maybe they'll be my friends.
And they're so soft. Don't squeeze.
Oh, my God. So I rolled 5, 6 dice. I have a 1. That one missed.
That's bad.
I have a 4, 2 fives, and 2 sixes.
Well, what's your parry, Edison?
Edison's parry is a 4 minus 2.
Minus
2 because he is drunk.
So, 2 latch around Edison's legs, tangling him up. I need an agility roll to see if Edison takes the top.
Oh, okay.
At a minus 2. At a drunk state.
He's toppling.
And he got a 5 minus 2 is a 3.
So Edison does a face plant.
Oh! I bet you that would hurt if I could feel that.
You're going to feel tomorrow. If you're alive.
My epitaph will be especially
2 more jump on Edison. Start trying to strangle him.
Otherwise, Edison. No body temperatures.
And the third one grabs on, trying to tangle around his legs to keep him from moving.
So we run, boys.
Some battles in Savage Worlds are not meant to be won.
That's it. Sometimes we run, boys.
You're supposed to tell us this before the battle. All
right.
We're just starting. I got to see how you get out of it. These guys aren't going away.
Well, the first
Come
one
on, this is the creepiest thing I've thrown out in a long time.
this is worse than this is by the hands.
Adam's going to go home and have nightmares tonight.
One low.
One low's up.
Can I get to Edison?
Yeah, you can speak. Bye.
Alright. I go to Edison and I try to pull the bear.
Don't forget you're leaving one behind you in the bedroom before that.
I'll move
yourself to that bear. So hard thing.
He has to act.
Ah. Yeah.
Alright, so he rushes out and tries to attack Juan Lowe, who's the only one in front of him. He rolls a 1. He gets caught in a burnt, broken floorboard, ripping a hole in his leg.
Oh. Little fluffy comes
out. You almost think you hear him think, oh, pretty sadly.
Good.
You should go try to see if he's okay.
You know, you need a little thread.
Medic.
You know what their worst is?
Seamstress.
Glue. Their worst should grab glue.
Go ahead,
all right, so I watch this teddy bear face plant, and I go and help Edison. And there's one around your throat, around your neck.
Two around his neck, and 3 more on his legs.
I try and grab one around his neck. I want to grab an arm in each hand to pull it apart, and I want to try and keep pulling, try and pull the arms.
Drag him into the room.
Okay. As soon as you grab on it, it's almost like a piece of steel. I mean, it's like, holy shit, this is not a stuffed teddy bear.
It's almost as strong as me.
All right, what am I rolling?
Strength. You're going to try to pull it off.
Strength? I think my strength is D4. Okay, strength is his D6. Jesus, what is in the D6 for me?
Yeah, jacked. Low.
Well, D6 is average.
He's wiry.
He's a wiry Irishman.
A 3. Supposed strength? Since you're trying to hold on and I'm trying to pull you off?
They have 10. Look at his smirk. He's like, whatever.
5. You are astonished by how strong it is.
Drag him.
I've already used my action and my move.
You're screwed.
It was nice knowing you guys.
Yep. Yeah, Edison should be saying that, not you.
Yoink. Oh, wait until they go first next round. Right there. That's the end of my turn.
Wait,
what can I do?
You have martial arts. Did you add your martial arts bonus to
not to a strength check. It's not a fighting check.
Oh, okay.
If he tried to kick it off, that would have been a different game. But
I'm trying to pry it off. Like if he's wrapped around your neck, I'm trying to pry it off.
What did your dojo teach you?
You haven't fought this thing either.
Drunken monkey teddy bear move.
Drunken teddy bear.
All right, who's next?
Now it becomes Ford Prefect.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Hiding in the bathroom.
I don't know.
It's where everybody should be. I'm just a smart one who got there. All right, I make my way out, and let's see if I can distract some of them. What is it? One's on your neck, right?
2.
Yeah, but they're on the other side of the hall.
I'd have to run and do that.
You're not getting back to the bathroom if you go over there. Where your light is?
In the bathroom.
You can light your Molotov cocktail if you want to try that.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, please, your phone? Is it a grandfather data plan, or is it a newer? How attached are you to that phone?
Phone's unlimited.
Phone's unlimited?
Yeah. It has all my pictures on it because I'm a journalist.
Are you paying for it, or are your parents paying for it?
My parents.
Oh, your parents are.
Oh, okay. Actually, no, they're not paying for it.
Are you saving to the cloud? Are you saving to the cloud?
I was going to say, you don't have cloud backup?
All right.
Said none died in the fire, right?
Yeah. No humans. Teddy bears apparently got burned up and came back and are trying to kill us.
I'm gonna while they're having fun, I'm gonna investigate the bathroom, see if there's any
You find a sink and a toilet.
Lord help me.
Because it's a fucking bathroom.
Help me.
Actually, you find a couple of showers. Two regular showers, one I guess that's a handicapped shower on the end there.
Oh jeez.
Maybe we can drown them. I'm just thinking.
2 more toilets.
And a dead body becomes alive.
And that is...
There could be another exit.
Because I always have an extra exit.
One entrance.
That's it, huh?
Probably not.
Unless it's like Harry Potter, we get the toilets and flush ourselves into the ultimate mystery of magic. Try it, Chris.
I mean, it's a standard bathroom. There's sinks, toilets, showers. It's a mess. You know, the places...
It's like you'd expect a bathroom to look like after a fire.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to have to run out to
this. This also has fire damage?
Now that I check.
Everything's got fire damage.
All right, Edison, I'm running to you, and that's all I'm going to do.
All right, so you make it to the H. You get to Edison.
You picked up your phone, and then you ran.
No, my phone's in there, lighting it up.
In the bathroom?
Yeah. I don't want anything else getting in there.
Okay.
Because that's our eventual a point of escape.
Where are we
going?
Point of
escape is
that's a dead end.
That's a dead end.
Vents.
But we have stairs.
It's a house. That's for that big.
Hey, hey.
All right, who's next?
Well, after that, we have
a house
Edison.
From 1902.
His smarts is a D4, by the way. His smarts is a D4.
Oh, so you're not a very good journalism major.
It's about right. No, I had a D6.
So Edison is, he's got two of the things on his neck. He's got two on his legs. He's on the ground.
I'm also impressed.
He's got one on his chest. Is that right?
Three on the legs, two on his neck.
So I think he's going to proceed to cry like a little
those
girl.
Knives
okay, so I think we're going to need a bigger check to see if the choking has had an impact.
Okay. Bigger check it is.
And that's only going to be the minus one because your adrenaline's kicking in at this point.
Okay. It's six explosion. And a four is 10, minus one is a 9.
All right, so your adrenaline is cranking through the roof right now. The alcohol is metabolizing at an astonishing rate. You can almost see straight.
Wow.
Well, that would
but next turn, they're going to be
choking you.
If they're still choking you, next turn, they'll have a minus on that right bigger roll. Because
okay.
Because you'll have no win for that much time.
You're so big.
You can act now with just the minus one.
Gotcha. Well, then.
You should put your hand in between so they're not choking you like they teach you in non-choke school.
He's going to stick his hand between his neck and see if he can ease up some air and break the hold. But also, he's going to. He's on his back,
tickle
I assume.
Him.
He was trying to get away, as my vision, so they grabbed him and he went more face down.
Face down. So he'll be trying to crawl back towards the way that we came towards his friends down the hall. Closer to...
There's a bathroom.
Okay, so you're crawling toward the L's in the hall.
Or the other way.
Where's the massive, his team of the fellow students?
Right there.
Right around the word hall.
Well, he's going to the L's in hall. Yes.
Okay. So he's going to try to crawl.
And try to... break something off of his neck if he can.
You can have one arm free.
One or the other.
Oh, it's one or the other.
I mean, how are you going to crawl with... Your legs are tangled up.
Okay.
So
then
you really can only crawl.
He's going to try to break the hold on his neck.
All right, so there's an opposed strength check.
Okay.
Versus one of the bears.
D4 strength. And, he's got a D...
There's got to be a little give on that.
D4
stuff,
bigger, D6 strength.
I just used a Betty for a creature.
Oh, boy.
And he rolls a 4 minus 1 is a 3.
Benny that, baby.
I rolled a 5.
Okay, he'll go one more time.
Yeah, that's it.
Here's a Benny.
I used one.
Yeah.
To keep my 5.
And he has a 5 minus 1 is a 4.
Oh. He pulls it. He gets it apart a little bit. He's able to choke it. And
then
just back down again.
Seam rip. Why are you at a minus 1?
Because he's drunk. And actually,
but you adrenalized.
Yeah, he's choking.
Yeah, he went from minus 2
minus
to minus 1.
Minus, oh, remember he used his MacGyver edge to make a better drink?
Yeah.
Which probably wasn't.
You had 2 cups of coffee, though.
That would have been perfect for you.
Yeah,
he's had the pee. Poo soon.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for Edison.
We know where the bathroom is.
And now we're on to Johnny Moon. And then it's going to be Joe Diffie.
Johnny Moon.
What made the
Johnny
sandwich?
I don't know.
That's my lunch for tomorrow.
I love that.
Thanks, brother.
It. Everybody like, where'd you get that? Poker.
I know a guy who knows a guy.
I got
I've won it in poker.
Alright,
so who's up?
I barely.
Coach East, you're up.
Get out of there.
I'm going to go and try to help Edison.
Alright.
There was this bear.
I'm going to pull the head back and just try to chop everything off that I can.
Are you going specifically for the arms?
The bears
or
Edison? I just want to clarify.
If you nick them, it's okay.
It's a polar bear, by the way. It's not a round.
Oh. I'm going to lift up and slice down, possibly severing all 4 limbs.
You're going crazy, huh? Is that a called shot?
That's going to be a called shot.
You got to aim.
Which is what, minus 2?
Yeah.
Fighting?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, here it is. Big
I'm
time.
Doing it.
I know, it's big time. You got 16 bennies.
It is.
That's not going to work. All right, here we go.
4 is not bad, but not great.
Not the best.
6.
10 minus 2 is 8.
8, all right. Who's ever built a stuffed animal, build a bear?
What do you call
you're asking a bunch of guys?
A creepy bear with no arms and no legs.
Head.
What do you put in the bear?
Floating
or stuffed animal.
Oh, like a little one of those little heart things.
Cochise grabs the thing, lives it in half. Stuffing goes everywhere, and Cochise notices a little toy heart, a little stuffed heart comes popping out.
That would have been cool if it was a real heart.
What is it? What do the toy hearts look like? I've never seen one.
It's just a little stuffed heart. It's like that big.
In the shape of a heart.
So it's not plastic. It's like a plush.
Step on it.
Gotcha. Just curious.
No, kids can choke on that.
So it pops off. Into the bear.
Into Edison's mouth, and he chokes
it up.
And
so all right, so Edison still has one choking him. One has been dismembered by Cochise.
Thank you, Cochise.
Who's up next?
Now we have Joe Diffie.
Joey D,
I showed you how to do it.
All right, so...
It is considered a called shot, so it's minus two.
Minus two, right? I'm fighting. All right, let's try to hack the arms off the bear.
Well, Jeff cut it all the way in half. Are you just going to cut one arm off and try to free Edison to breathe?
Yeah, I just want one arm off so that he can breathe.
Okay, that's not. I'm not gonna make that a call and shot.
Okay. Nine.
Joe Diffie adroitly flips out the knife. Off comes the arm. Stuffing goes everywhere. Edison gets a deep breath in.
The deep breath.
There's still three more tangled around his legs, but he can breathe again.
Well, that's all right. They can squeeze your legs all they want.
At this point, we all have our moves, or no?
Chris does not.
I do not.
Edison does not. He had one action only.
You guys had to move to help. So,
Can Johnny and I drag Edison into the bathroom?
I came out.
No, you had to move to get there.
Okay. I thought you were with me. Standing
yeah,
next
but you guys
to me.
Had to go back further down the hall to get to Edison. He was last. You guys are around the second L in hall on the map. Edison was back in front of one of the doors you haven't seen, almost at the corner. You see the map?
Yeah, no. I thought when you had said that everybody was within the word hall, so.
Maybe I made Edison a little further back.
Okay.
I'll let you drag him halfway there. Almost to the door. How's that?
Sure.
Deal him up, sir.
You got it. Oh. Ooh. Juan Lo with the ace. Edison with the queen.
Yo.
Johnny Moon with the nine. Oh!
Hey, finally.
4-3 pick has the Joker.
I got it.
Joe Diffie has the four clubs. And the bad guy, King of Diamonds.
Whoa.
Wow. Goodness.
How many are left?
Well, that was initially six, and now we're down to three.
And there's no others?
There's the one stuck in the... There's the one that...
Oh, the...
There's the initial one with no head and no one missing an arm. There's the one that came out of bedroom four that's stuck on the... He'll be free. There's the one that Jeff cut in half. That one hasn't moved.
I cut two in half, just for the record.
You beheaded one and cut his arm off, but it's not dead. There's the one you cut in half with the little heart that came out. That one hasn't moved. There's the one that Joe Diffie cut an arm off it so Edison could breathe. And then there's the three on Edison's legs that you've seen.
Got it. Well, with the Joker, I'd like to point out you can do wild attack, double attack. Don't forget your.
You have to have two weapons, though. I don't have the Joker. Chris does.
Oh.
I thought you were doing that in secret.
Or Prefect has the Joker. So you can still do.
Let them. Thanks.
You could do wild attack.
Well, if you do a double attack, you have, like if you, your second attack would have to be some kind of offhand attack.
Mm-hmm. So, now.
Get down.
Right out.
I thought it was longer. I was trying to poke her.
That was the least scared I've seen again.
Mikey, the cat just jumped on the couch.
She's laughing.
Adam, get down. And she just looked at him like,
no.
Then Adam said, I thought it was longer.
I tried to poke her with the mouse. Thought it was a mouse. She'd be afraid of it? No, wait.
That's what she said. No. She tries to stuff her pet mouse down the hole in the floor in the kitchen.
Where'd you go?
You could do a cold shot.
Josh was a joke to it. I know. Where'd you go?
For the heart.
Mm-hmm.
You can use your joker.
All right, I'm going to cleaver. I'm going to cleaver one in the heart.
You're going to stab into the one that's on Idison's leg.
I'm just going to chop it like that.
You're going to try to cut it in half?
Yeah.
You're going for the heart, though. You're
cutting it in half.
You don't know where the heart is. I mean, the heart just came out.
It's sewn in. It says heart right there.
I mean, but the torso is still good size.
It's a chunky bear.
Well, I thought that's the point of the called shot.
It's called
you do a
called
shot to try to aim for
it. Well, because he was trying to get it like, through the head and down the middle.
Okay.
I got a roll. What's a cleaver?
Fighting roll.
Fighting roll.
Oh,
D4? We just had a wild eye.
But yeah, it's wild. Crazy, too.
It's a wild and crazy die.
Plus two, or whatever you
do. Yeah, five.
Five you hit. So you're just trying to cut it in half. You're not trying to...
I'm just cutting it in half at this point.
All right.
Do I get anything with the Joker? Plus two?
Yeah, plus two.
Yeah, plus two.
Need damage roll.
Plus two.
Damage is a D4 plus strength.
But
plus strength. Two because of your Joker.
Plus two because of your Joker.
Seven?
Plus two?
Yep. Oh, do you add them all up?
Yes.
Yep.
If you want. If you want to hit them, yeah.
Remember I was doing it for a year wrong?
Yeah.
You're like, wow, your damage will stink. Yeah, I know. Probably should add in the extra six. But, eight.
All right, so
it's, what are your dice? You rolled a six and a two?
Four grabs the...
A one and a two.
A one, a five, and a two.
And the two from the Joker. Okay, all right.
So there were the two that initially grabbed Edison's legs and the one that jumped on top of that. Ford runs over there, picks up the head, slices the thing in half, and the arms are still flailing about.
Love it.
Stuffing starting to fly all over the place.
Guys, I'm allergic to latex polyester composites. Achoo!
My wounds are swelling.
It is probably polyester polypropylene mix.
Sorry. All right. Edison has two left on him. These are clamped solidly to his legs.
Is the one that Chris just cut his head off still clamped on his leg too?
Yes.
Yeah, you get a move.
I'm going to drag him towards the next person and closer to the bathroom.
Well, is drag a move though?
No. All right,
forget it. I'm not moving.
Drag is an action.
Drag is an action.
Plus, move.
You have Edison grab around your foot, and you just walk. And drag it up.
Walk this way.
Drop our piston up.
All right, who's up?
Oh, now it's
Leibniz. So one of them is going to reach down into the... He's going to get on the ground and down into the body of the one that was on... That its head cut off. And you're going to try and pull out the batting and try and...
Okay, so the one that's still... Oh, the one that's trying to crawl across.
It's like Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Okay, so the one that's got one arm and two legs and is still dragging itself across the floor.
No. The one that's on Edison's leg.
Okay, the one that he just got half.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to reach in there.
Yeah, I want to reach into the body.
Seems like a good idea.
Really?
Yeah. He's trying to go for that heart.
Okay, that's going to be... I don't know how to roll that. Is that a called shot?
I
think it's a plus seven.
I'd go called shot. Why not?
I'm going to call it a minus one.
On an attack roll? On a fight roll?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it is without a head, so, yeah, that maybe balances out.
And it's not trying to evade me, because it's just trying to hold on.
Yeah, but the amount of rolling around on the ground,
yeah,
I think makes it a minus one.
Joe Dippy, see if you can get psychically attached to him. I bet they're swearing us up and down now. They're trying to just be friends.
Yes, yeah, but plus one for my...
We just want love.
Martial arts plus, so it cancels out the natural
sword.
Plus one, minus one.
Alright, so you reach in there, you grab a handful of stuffing, yank it out.
And I just want to keep doing that. Until I see the heart come out. Or if I don't see it, I'm just going to keep ripping stuffing out.
Okay. So, you pull the stuffing out, now it's like snow.
It's evil stuffing, it gets in your throat.
You're all sneezing now.
It's
coffee.
Like
you realize that if these are old teddy bears in the 1950s, that's asbestos. That's
they're only crazy. The house only burned down like 3 or 4 years earlier.
Okay, thank God.
If you'll recall.
Or so we think.
So the teddy bear seems to... This could be the house that burned down before the house that burned down.
Oh.
Ooh, I hadn't thought of that. I like that.
Oh, God.
The bears were an alpha pie.
Yeah.
So whatever it was, it had to be alpha pie house.
It's always been an alpha pie house.
Alpha pie.
I love alpha pie.
I know.
Actually, you know what we do know, though? Wasn't it Teddy Roosevelt after whom the teddy bear was named after? So we know that it was after the era of Teddy Roosevelt.
Well, that's not fun.
Where's Joel? The one time we needed him.
Call Joel. Well, he's not.
All right. So,
so
you reach in there, you pull it out, you throw it off to the side, you see something red come out of the corner of your eye.
That's my spleen.
And it seems the teddy bear stops moving.
And then I got nothing else to do there. Fiend.
You know, now you do the ooh, and then you do the kung fu position, and then you extend your right hand outwards, palm upwards, and then you flick twice, like come.
Yeah.
The next one.
No, after.
So the next one that's grabbed on.
No, after he fights, he's gotta go.
Oh, very Bruce Lee. Yes.
That's after you.
The
sheep. All right, so it's the
muscle
bear's push. Time.
It's the bear's turn.
Two left that we, two, three left. That we know.
Right.
Still my
alpha.
You hear more scampering, I guess is the right term I want to use, running in motion from down here.
It's soft like
and you know,
soft
I said,
like kittens.
Not that I'm complaining, but you have that dress is small.
What are you two looking at over there?
We're trying to get in the spirit of things. We're looking at sorority pictures.
All right, so there's more activity from the other end of the hallway. It sounds like there are more coming.
Look.
The the one that was stuck in bedroom 4 has unstuck itself. It has come out, and it is attacking.
That's the headless one.
No.
Oh.
There's,
that's the one that jumped at me, and I knocked it down.
Oh, the
and then it tried to run at me, and it got caught on a floorboard.
And now it's...
So it has unstuck itself. It comes out. The person who is furthest down the hall for the bathroom, I believe, is back to being 4.
Yeah, I would drag. Yeah, I would say it's me.
So it leaps it forward.
This thing likes to jump.
It can't get forward. Like a locomotive.
2.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm slippery, man. What's up?
Ford puts his hands up by the little girl.
No!
Yeah.
And it jumps by. But very manly.
It does not tangle around your throat, so you hold off the dire teddy bear.
I'm constantly like this, though.
Yeah.
Try to choke me.
Hoping nothing gets inside the guard.
Try to choke me now.
All right, the two that are on Edison's legs try to crawl up to his throat.
But they don't crawl up someplace else?
No.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, that would be like, what do you do with that part of your body anyway, Edison?
Well, I use it to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, but it's
and hopefully not get hit in.
It's all whiskified. You won't feel it anyway.
Wow, what else would you do with it? I don't understand
Joe Dippy.
I'm trying to figure out how to make this happen. Is it a fighting roll? Do I get a bonus for already being on top?
Yeah, you get a bonus.
And are they trying to attack him?
Well, they tangled up his legs and knocked him down. So they're clinging onto that. Now they want to climb up his body while he's on the ground and try to strangle him.
I would argue you get a gang up bonus because it's 2-on-1.
Sure.
Also, you have...
And they are both there already.
Yep,
they're
both there.
So they
both
get +1.
Uh-huh. And then on top of that, I would say that you have a person who's on the ground, so easily another +1. Or maybe
but there's also 2 people on top of you who are on the, like, right there as well.
I'd argue at least a +2.
His boss.
I mean, I don't know. It's one of those things where, yeah, are we going to let them just crawl up him?
Well, they're
but you already pulled
it.
One off this turn, too.
Yeah, they're doing it.
You dismantled one.
You're not letting them do that.
They're doing it while it's happening.
Wow. A 1 and a 2.
I guess that makes the whole point. But they're able to get up around his neck area. Okay.
Yes, they're both on his back, but neither of them are strangling him. So you could actually stand up and run at this point.
Wow.
For about 5 seconds before they choke you.
Yeah.
You drop down, hit your face again.
Do I have any others to work
which
with?
Okay, won't feel it.
The one that had the single arm and 2 legs that was tied around Joe Diffie's leg is still there.
All we need to do is shove 1-on-1 leg off. They can't choke.
Yeah.
He's pretty ineffective at this point.
Oh, we can get one out of here.
Rip the turn out and squeeze it. Whatever's there.
I don't think I have any more, but without a doubt,
there's more coming.
There's more coming. In fact, you see, I'll make it more creepy.
It's a fucking
While Lo looks up and sees two crawling across the ceiling.
Ah! Oh, that's creepy.
Guys, we gotta get out of here.
Like a ball pit?
John and Moon,
we're almost to the chase through the house that I've been trying to get to for an hour.
Oh,
out of here like a ball.
It's okay, though. It's been a fun movie car.
I'm thinking, like, I'm really thinking that we're supposed to investigate down here and find out what's going on.
You're supposed to run through, you're supposed to find your way down to the basement here.
We're there. We made it. Let's go
back.
Oh,
dear God.
No, you're on the second floor of the old house.
Oh, we gotta go down.
Yeah, so you realize, like, we're somehow in another dimension or back in time or something. Yeah.
Or just stuck
all
in the
this
hall.
Timey-wimey stuff.
Where are they coming from?
Most of them are coming from the south.
This side?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
All right, let's go this way then.
And the two that Wanlo saw are on the ceiling there.
Wanlo was still, like, at this corner?
We're on the H.
Yeah.
So they came out of one of the rooms, the other bedroom, maybe bedroom, which your guess is five, two crawled out on the ceiling.
Dancing.
All right, who is next?
Edison is next. So he's got two of them on his chest. Just about to grab his neck.
Get up and running, boys.
So he gets up.
You're face down, and they're on your back. So you could push yourself up and start to run if that's what you wanted to do.
Got it.
Ooh, ram your back into a wall like that. It always works on movies.
He's going to.
Yeah, because they're stuffed.
Can he stand up and then like do like you know in judo you do a throw you throw somebody over your back
like the Muppets.
Except it's like you have a Muppet on your back and you're grabbing him and you're doing a judo throw.
You can try.
Okay.
Judo chop.
Who's next?
They're
after
very
you?
Strong.
After Edison, we've got.
Also, Edison jumps up.
Johnny Moon and then Joe Dippy.
So Edison pops up somehow, adrenaline flowing.
Do you want to tell me that you back? Wait until I get ready. I'm ready to chop.
Okay. Edison says, Johnny Moon! I'm gonna get this monkey off my back.
I say
this needs the good, bad, and ugly.
I put my neck down. Yeah. No, this isn't a monkey. It looks like it's a teddy. Oh wait.
pick up your knife, Johnny Moon. I'm gonna throw it to you.
I got my knife ready.
Your slasher.
You need a slash
I'm ready
out of the
for
air.
It. Yeah.
Actually, I hope you roll a one.
Johnny Moon, I just have to let you know, I've been chosen the last in team dodgeball and softball for the past 19 years.
A little bit less.
Right, okay. What do you recommend?
Roll a lucky roll?
Strength?
I guess call strength. It'll be a post-strength check.
All right. His strength is D4. Okay.
Got this.
Wild.
So my strength is a D6 who plays college football. And his is a D4, the pencil-necked geek, weak leg.
Well, that's because you're a quarterback. If you were a linebacker, you'd be a D8.
You played high school quarterback going on in college, you played linebacker.
So Edison failed his first role, and he just wasted a minute.
Well, I don't know. Do we know what the opposed role is?
And he failed the second role, too.
No, it's an opposed role. What if he rolled a one?
He rolled his first roll was a 3.
No, Josh has to roll 2.
Oh, all right. Okay. But his first roll was a 3 minus the drunken factor.
Just let it go.
Yeah, it's not happening. Yeah.
Do you want that paid back? Because I rolled a 7. I should have
no,
that
no,
too.
No.
I wait. I see he can't get it off. I'm up next.
You are. It's your
I run up there and slice.
Can't get it off.
Do the same thing.
He's going to do that anyway.
How about
shot to the heart?
Tall shot.
Tall shot. Try to slice this one half again.
Try to slice it in half again.
If you made it a wild attack, you get a plus 2 or something.
Yeah, and then he'd hack your neck off.
Meh. Yeah, you got this.
No.
You gotta save the Bennies for soaking.
He is lucky, though. He is lucky. He's got one more.
4.
What's his parry?
I rolled a regular straight up 4. That means a 2.
I'm gonna let you cut the arm off it.
I rolled 5 threes.
My goodness.
5 out of 6 rolls were a 3.
Could have been a Yahtzee.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Could have
sounded
you don't want to do Yahtzee on a 3, though, it's kind of lame.
Yeah, it's hard.
All right, so you're able to grab one, mop the arm off,
I don't
hold off Edison's back, but it's still struggling. Are you going
to go? I try to pull Edison up the hallway.
Yeah, but Edison can move.
Yeah.
The other one
I'm pulling up the hallway.
So the one that was on his back, you tossed off?
I tried to.
Okay, you cut one arm, tossed it off.
And we go up the hallway.
You're tossing
and there's still one on Edison and one more on Edison. Joe Diffie?
Yep.
Joe Diffie, we want to try to get to the right.
Okay, I'm in.
Oh, it's okay, well.
All right, there's one, there's several behind you. You can't see them, and you can only hear them off to the left. There's the two on the ceiling that are creeping.
But they're far away from us.
That are creeping at them out.
Is there a mop or a broom in the bathroom?
Did I see one? Ford?
It's charred.
Charred, yes.
So you have no idea if it's how useful it is. You have the one on your leg, Mike, that's got one arm and two legs and is not hurting you other than annoying you. And
okay.
The one that is on Edison's back. And there's one that tried to attack Ford that missed. A lot of choices.
So, is anybody in danger? Other, you know.
Edison may get choked soon.
Yeah, the one on his back will try to choke him next turn.
How close is Edison to me? Is he still next to me?
Close enough.
Close enough, Mikey.
Okay.
Close enough.
I'm gonna.
That's a standard line in my house.
I'm gonna attempt to rip the chest open.
Of
like cut the body of the bear open, and rip the heart out.
Going for it. All right, it's a called shot, so it's a minus four. Joe Dippy don't need no.
He don't need no minus.
You know, if Joe had his gun, he can just shoot the bear as it's on his back. Right through bottom.
Minus four?
Yes.
That's it?
Benny time?
I just wanted to make sure. So, seven.
With the minus four?
Yes.
So you rolled an 11?
Yes.
All right. You're able to slice it open, rip it, stuffing flies everywhere, the heart flies out.
Step on it.
And the thing, it's just almost like a, I don't want to say a skin, but it's just the outside of the stuffed animal now, limp in your hands.
Is it still moving?
No. Other than the one that is now tangled on Joe Diffie's leg, nobody else is encumbered by one.
Woohoo!
In fact, I should make a check for the one on Joe Diffie's leg to see if it got knocked off. It did. So you are not encumbered at this point. Like I said, there's several ahead. There's several, two on the ceiling and several behind you.
Run.
Did you get your phone?
I got my phone.
No.
Yo. Just saw a turn this round?
I'm not running in there. They'll trap me in there. You're nuts.
Whose turn is it? Who hasn't gone yet? Whose turn is it?
That's the end of the round. Yeah. And I have to reshuffle since we have a joker?
Well, that's what the other deck is for. It's supposed to be pre-shuffled.
Yeah, it is pre-shuffled.
Okay.
Next round.
Okay.
Really no, good. You're banned.
I really don't want
like, I will fumble through shuffling cards.
Queen.
Touch them.
Queen. 10. 2. 3.
Oh, gosh. Mikey's
nine.
Unlucky. So, the order that we have now is clubs for diamonds. So, Edison, followed by Juan Lowe, then Johnny Moon, then the bad guys, then Joe Diffie, and then Ford Prefect.
Yay.
No,
that
is... So
I go before you, Bob.
Oh, okay.
In the interest of...
Reverse alphabetical. Oh, yeah. Diamonds, four clubs, sorry.
In the interest of making this... You guys will run on whoever runs first.
So
if Adam or Bob say run, as a group you can all run. You'll have to deal with two on the ceiling.
Well,
and
I wanted
to
try and find the mop in the bathroom and see if it would, how bad it, see if I can grab it.
You can't clean up this area. Just get the hell out.
I just
want
to clean off the ceiling.
Oh, look at all the dirt. Oh, boy.
What did Coach used to become Jewish?
Jewish grandmother, I don't know.
Johnny Moonstein?
Johnny Moonberg?
So, who's first?
That'll be Juan Lowe. Listen, Juan Lowe wants to run into the bathroom and grab the mop.
Gotta go, huh?
Gotta go right now.
All right, Juan Lowe runs into the bathroom. Get your notice check.
The light's on.
Actually, I will reveal that there's a... hold on a second. There's a small closet here.
It's probably a linen closet.
With a broom in it.
Perhaps.
Instead of going into the bathroom, I'll open that closet.
All right.
Let's say
there's not two bears in there.
Give me a notice check. We'll call it a luck check at this point. It's not like you can do a survival check or something.
fuck you.
So you roll well?
Yeah, I rolled fucking fantastic. There we go. Five.
Five. You find a broomstick, only halfway burned through. So you have about 3 feet of stick out of it.
That should be all I need to reach the ceiling in the residence.
You roll again to find a mop bucket.
You?
To throw up in?
Give me a bucket.
You, personally, 3 feet wouldn't be enough, but...
Well, then why do I have to tuck my... Oh, never mind. I could reach the ceiling with a 3-foot thing, a regular ceiling, not your freaking vaulted ceilings here.
You're crazy.
All right, so you have your stick.
So Johnny Moon grabs the rod, and...
There he goes.
And he tries to be...
Yeah.
I thought he was going to plug her ears. He will shake his rod and try to beat the bears off the ceiling. Is he able to get both of them or just one?
For those of you who are just tuning into our game, he's talking about...
Talking about killer stuffed polar bears trying to attack us and kill us.
And not with his rod, but with a...
With a broomstick. Yeah. Not a broomstick.
For clarification,
You're gonna get one.
All right.
Unless you roll super well, you're gonna get one.
All right. So it's a fighting roll.
I guess it's a fighting roll, yes.
And I'm just trying to like whack them off to the sides.
Whack-a-doodle, baby. Whack
a
off.
A little whacker. It's a four.
Whack a bear.
So you hit one.
I hit one. Like I said, I'm trying to swing sideways, so it goes.
You hit one. I rolled a one. It looks like you're hitting a ball with a bat. It needs to sail behind you.
Nice. He misses by a mile.
Pour him off the ceiling.
Did you point first?
Did you call it?
I know, because I never minus four. It was not called shot, though.
No. All right. Who's next, then? Edison
next
is next. Is Edison going to initiate the run?
Is going to...
Edison is clear, I believe.
Somebody's got to say run.
Oh, yeah.
Before they get there.
Edison says, Guys, I think after much deliberation and calculation, it seems to me that the only foregone conclusion at this point would be to exercise our ability to run. Run!
I wanted somebody to break in and yell at you to do that. That was too obvious if I did. Run, Edison. Come on, get your move on.
I run.
Run. What?
Run.
Oh, yes, I have the press. Fresh off the presses.
So Edison runs.
All right. Everybody takes off after Edison, heading down the hall to the right.
Yes.
We are going to do a chase tonight. And damn it, we're going to do it right.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
You know, I feel like the chase mechanics of Savage Worlds, Adam Savage Worlds, are equivalent to the... Was it the skill challenge mechanic of
40? No, I got it now. I totally got it now.
No, I mean, how exciting they are.
Because this is a foot chase, so it's much easier than the other ones.
Than the boat chase?
Because everybody has the skill that's required for a foot chase. So here's how it works.
So we're going to try and shoehorn skills into this thing.
Everybody,
a skill challenge.
Everybody makes an agility check.
Okay.
Okay? For each success and raise on the agility check... You draw an action card. Okay? And then you play the highest card you get when we determine the order of things.
Alright.
I would use a reshuffled deck, Bob.
Yeah, I will. It's right here. Here's the reshuffled deck.
So agility check, everybody.
Everybody make an agility check.
Oh, I got a six.
I do the thing?
Yes.
Again, college football player. D6.
12.
4.
That's good. That's still a raise. 13. Wow. I got 3. I get 3 cards?
You get 3 cards.
Johnny Moon gets 4. A card. You got a 4. That's a card. We're up to 5 cards.
Edison got a 3 with his drunkenness minus 2. Puts him down to 1.
You're okay. Minus 1, Bob. You're only down. You're minus 1. Mikey, what did you get for your agility check?
7.
7.
That's
right.
Another card. We get 6 cards.
6 cards it is? Just
actually,
it's
supposed to be individual.
What do you mean? Oh, we each get?
Yes, you get what you get.
So
you get the
three.
Oh,
okay.
You don't
so
get
I got 3
it.
Cards.
2, 3. How many did Johnny Moon get?
4.
You got
4.
So it's 1 card.
1 card for him.
Okay. How many did you
one
get?
1 card for Chris.
And how many did Mikey get?
Mikey gets one card, as well, he got seven.
Oh, I get one though.
Do I show it or not?
Yeah, you, yeah.
Okay.
Wow, I took some bad cards.
Mikey, your card is an eight of
no,
hearts.
You gotta...
Jeff.
All right, and I need you to deal me... the Bears aren't going to have any cards this turn. So here's how it works. A character with a higher card than a foe is said to have an advantage over him. This is abstract, so it may mean the character is ahead, behind, or even parallel to his foe. The important thing is that he is somehow maneuvered in such a way as to gain a superior position and bring his weapons to bear.
Get it?
Alpha Phi shirt.
Do you
think
offer them Coke?
I was just
going to
say, I picture the Coca-Cola Bears.
You're right, I don't like chase mechanics.
Really?
I don't like
the
chase mechanics.
You're doing so well
so far. Yeah, I know, but then it gets it doesn't make sense.
Hmm.
It's.
Listen, the thing is, it's like... It's
I need to find... I need to have somebody show us how it works.
An example.
If only there was a place where you could, like... People could, like, take a video of them doing something and, like, put it somewhere where anybody can view it.
Yeah.
That would be great. And make it searchable.
That would be nice.
Okay.
Or
you guys run, race down the hallway. The Bears are behind you.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
You stumble upon a staircase here on your right.
Stumble upon it, not stumble down it.
So wait, are we avoiding?
Looking at it, you are definitely gonna have a chance of stumbling down or breaking through or falling through. This staircase is definitely worse for wear. Steps are missing.
Oh boy.
It looks like the fire probably came through this section.
So hold on, lady. We're going for a ride.
Knowing what you know, Edison. There would be another point of egress.
Know what I know, there'd be another point of egress.
Not just the one, it'd be the staircase.
Speak English, Edison. What do you mean?
There's another way out.
Well, if this is the same house, there's the elevator, perhaps the dumbwaiter.
Not the same house. The old house.
Well, it's the vegetable.
We didn't look at the plants in the old house?
You did, but you didn't see this one.
Oh.
This was the house.
Okay, so we keep running?
All right, let's go down.
These stairs?
Yeah.
You
first.
No. Let's look for the other staircase. Come on, let's keep going.
It's bear.
A big square.
You keep running.
You run past here. You know two bears coming out of the other corner bedroom. Ping that for you.
Uh-huh.
So two more bears come running out of there.
Oh, boy.
They're actually pretty cute when they run. The little arms go, legs go.
Yeah, but
put the card back. Put the card, Jeff.
I think down.
We don't need cards.
You don't need the card.
I think down the stairs.
Are we on this for no reason?
Yeah.
So he aborted. We're not doing the chase.
So I did not see the chase.
It's
still
close. I had a king of spades, and I ate a deuce of hearts and four diamonds too.
I am not even looking at it.
It is a. Oh, it was the one I jacked. It'd be fantastic.
Tease.
You made the turn. Why don't we deal another round of cards here, Bob?
Okay. Should I shuffle again, or
it might be worth us
whatever you want.
We'll leave those out.
Sure.
And initiative one more time.
Round
oh.
Over.
Hey, seven again. That's just you're the best, Bob.
Oh, Mikey got something. Here.
Is it because I didn't give you a good Christmas?
Well,
all right, there we go. There we go. So we have the Joker once again. Edison's got a Joker. Then it is Juan Lowe, then Joe Diffie, and then we've got Johnny Moon, and then we've got Ford Prefect, and then the Teddy Bears go.
And then Dub Bears.
Dub Bears.
There we are.
Rick Bears.
All right, so you're rounding the corner here where it says store, which obviously storage.
Oh, I thought that
was a store. That was
a little shop.
Yeah.
Like, is it a weapon shop? Is it, you know?
That'll be five gold pieces.
Two more bears. Come on. Two more bears come out of this room as you're making the turn.
It's a little creepy.
Guys, I think
there's at least a dozen behind
there.
You, as far as you can tell.
There's a great hall.
It's a big hall. There's more rooms ahead. I know that there where it's sleeping. If you haven't gotten it yet. So, running, stand and fight. Got a room.
Running.
Still running, I think.
Run.
Is anybody gonna take a pot shot at one of them as you go by? And
I want to kick one. I'm gonna try to kick it back into the room.
All right.
Edison will try a kick as well.
I will too, because I'm a good kicker.
I'm gonna try a bite.
I actually kicked in high school.
Oh. And in the meantime, through my head, all I hear is, this. Oh man, my timing was off.
Good work.
I may not agree with you, John Moon, but I'll defend your right to bear arms.
If you can't hear him, Mike, he's playing the Benny theme. Benny Hill theme.
Oh, okay.
Oop, fell down.
Wait, wait. Give me the time when we go by.
Yeah.
Stocking cigar belts, everyone.
That's what I'm picturing playing in my head through this whole thing.
Fine, when it comes up, just call like a nurse.
Ah, yeah.
So,
burn and scar hideously.
Creepy nurse.
Yeah.
Creepy nurse polar bear.
All right, you make the turn around the corner. There's several in the hallway in the way.
Oh, in the hallway.
And the hallway doorways, whatever you out. You know, there's several that are impacting your ability to get by.
One more wants to try to kick one back into the room. All
right. They go last, so go ahead. You tap me off. You get the
okay. Is it straight fighting?
Well, we'll go in order.
Edison, the most useless one in the group.
Yep.
That's no, he's the most useful because he has plus two.
I got the plus two.
Now.
I want you to pull. You to pull muscle as well.
5 plus 2 is 7, minus 1 for being drunk is 6.
Edison successfully plants one on the kisser of the bear. What's
just the bear?
Kick is, untrained kick is just deep. Is
just
strength?
Strength.
You know, it's just kind of something like pushes. I don't think we're trying to do any damage. We're just trying to, like, hunt him
away. Alright, so I'm just.
The girl.
I'm just going to give you the success of getting rid of knocking it out of the way.
Okay.
Is that Simpsons?
Boink. Edison somehow. Edison then press everybody kicks one, and it falls over.
Well, let's try to do that.
Edison almost falls over himself, and then catches himself, and then grins and goes, "Whew, that's close."
All the
keep moving.
You're still running.
Are you kicking or are you using your pole?
Oh,
Edison's very lightweight.
I was kicking.
Plus, the guy that
and I just must have been trying to. I'm coming around the corner so fast, I'm trying to like kick on the mold, and it just like all I did is kind of trip me up a little bit.
You kick the
guy
door.
Didn't fall over.
You kick the door frame, breaking the door frame.
Nice.
But you missed the bear.
Damn.
The door frame fell on him.
Oh no!
All right, who's next?
Our next up is Joe Diffie.
Joe Diffie. He's either just kicking ones out of the way. You're making the turn. You're heading down the hall.
I'm going.
You just running?
Dead.
All right. You know what? I'm gonna say. In a minute, I'm going to make everybody make an agility roll to make sure they don't trip or break anything.
Mm-hmm.
If you choose to attack, you get a minus one on that agility roll because you focused on that.
Big time.
All right. I won't enforce that this turn, but going forward, I will.
Okay.
There's no way we do that.
Is anybody else kicking?
I'm slashing with a cleaver.
Okay.
Any kind of attack.
Yeah.
Is distracting you from just... navigating through the dark. So any kind of attack is going to necessitate a minus one. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I run.
Minus one would represent either tripping on something, falling through the floor a little bit.
Yeah, I don't want to do that. Run it is.
Run it is.
I'm cautious.
I think we're losing my wife.
Nope. Good night, Amy.
Good night. 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 Good night.
Good night. Good night. Good
night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good
night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night.
Good
night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night.
I will do my best on the ball.
You gotta get Jules up.
Yeah, you're right. Jules 6:15.
It's not
like you can hide.
All right.
You've been back for a week now, right?
Tomorrow's
his first day.
Oh, tomorrow's his first day.
First day with students.
Oh, wow.
I've been back since Thursday, but.
Gotcha.
All right, so you make the turn, you make it down the hall.
And I have to learn all everybody's name for him.
Do the cue card thing and tell me something about yourself.
Oh, it's tough, and now you're going to be sleep deprived for that.
Yeah, we'll wrap up by midnight.
It's about 140 students. Actually.
All right, you guys are running down, and
class.
Quick, give me a note. Everybody give me a notice check.
Notice check.
Two.
That's a lot of names for him.
I got a 12.
Four.
Niner. See, here's the music that I'm thinking of.
during the scene. 10.
Yeah.
I couldn't place that music when you said that.
Scooby-Doo?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. I know that. So Ford finds, Ford says, whoa, guys, right here, here's the other staircase. And you can see the staircase, or you can see the D anchor down.
Do our feet just keep spinning?
It's just a
circular blur.
These stairs are not as treacherous. By the way, this area here was open to the downstairs, but there was no way you could have descended.
That's what I heard.
Everybody's got their own little thing on.
What the hell is this?
The Care Bears.
Alright. Shirt off.
Five, four, three, two, one.
I don't think this dance part.
This is good. You know what we need to do next time?
There's a whole dance to it.
I have a challenge for you guys.
Oh, this is your phone?
Next session. I want each of you to come up with a theme song for your character.
I just had it.
And then next session we will, at some point during the game night, reveal the theme song for our character, and you'll have to play it from your phone.
Every time it's our turn, we play the...
Every single... Like, if it's our turn to talk to somebody, the music plays.
That's good.
Longest session ever.
We run downstairs.
Carefully.
Down the stairs? This is down? Where do these stairs go?
I'm going to slide on my butt.
I need an agility check from everybody.
Agility?
There's two bears on the stairs.
9!
Oh.
Coaches leaps over the bears.
Fiber.
I'm going to help out anybody who might need help.
Not your team guy.
I'm like Simpson running through the airport
table
right now.
Should I spend my last penny on this?
Well, Mikey,
should I spend my time?
I rolled a 15. I'm like OJ running through the airport.
Oh my god, remember that?
Water,
he was on.
What'd you get, Addison?
He got a 2 after his drunken.
Mike is so getting his car.
Okay, so.
I rolled a 2. Addison tripped me up.
Since both Cochise and Joe Diffie made it with a raise. I will say that they were able to kick the two bears on the stairs out of the way. However, you guys still fell.
But we slid down the stairs, right?
Face first.
Whatever, man.
Whatever, man. So
you don't know where Von Lowe grew up. This ain't nothing.
Well, he does his own stunts. That what you're telling me?
Broken foot and everything. He gets a special shoe covering made for his cast. 2 and a 1.
Twice in a row?
Yeah.
So if you added it together, you'd be okay.
All 4 rolls.
He asked me what the chances are. I was trying to figure it out.
What's the same chance of rolling boxcars twice in a row? 6 × 6 × 6 × 6.
All right. Damage.
8%.
5 damage from the fall.
Over toughness. I think my toughness is 5.
He's like, I have 40 hit points.
It's what I'm like, how many hit points does that mean?
You too, Edison.
5.
Toughness
damage.
Is a 5, so is that a shaken?
Yes.
Okay.
His toughness is currently
so we have to
five.
Roll to get rid of shaken next round?
Yeah, you can move to keep up, but you can't act otherwise.
He is shaken as well. Okay.
You bump the bruise, you're going to feel that in the morning.
Hmm.
Well, actually, Edison's really going to worry about his head in the morning.
I'm
going to
feel a lot.
Yeah, but with the adrenaline, one load doesn't feel shit right now.
I hope he's not a blackout drunk, because that would be awesome.
Guys, why am I all bruised?
What did we do?
And why do I have stuff in my ear and now my... I've got these ligature marks, but they're like...
Is there any dead bears around this room?
There's the two that Cochise and...
hacked apart?
And Joe Diffie kicked over.
No, they're not dead.
He got by the way, but not
dead.
I
want to de-stuff him and wear one as a hat.
Like a coonskin cap or
yeah.
Like dragon.
That's it. Yeah. Bear hands out. Sucker. Be a warning to all other bears.
Can we get one on the way up?
Yeah, I am.
That's
it'd be
kind of
weird,
fun to kidnap one. Take it back up.
Interrogate it. Just watch his thumbs.
I wear somebody's face as a mask.
All right, so you make it down the stairs.
Kind of here.
Oh,
there. Oh, wow.
Steve Buscemi's character.
Nicholas Cage and Steve Buscemi.
You make it down the stairs. Since you're guessing based on what you've seen of other frat houses, this is probably the main floor.
Yeah.
you hear a scream from somewhere.
Oh, that stinks.
Okay. Sorry, that was me.
We
guys.
Figure out where that scream was from and run the opposite way. Yeah.
Wait, that was just me. Sorry. I got scared.
It was more like a help scream.
We don't care about that lady.
You're heroic.
No, I'm not. I am devout.
I listened for the last place the echo came from.
Yes.
And that's where I'm going to head.
Right. Well, really, you're going to come out of there and figure out where you're going
to
go.
We're going to go up to the right.
So you go there, or you can go there.
That doesn't help. Okay.
Go this way.
We go up into the hallway.
Let's split up.
You're heading up.
Split the party. I like it.
I like that.
Half people on this side of the couch go to the right. You guys go up.
Joe Diffie stands there and holds the staircase from the dozen bears that are coming down.
No, we just burn the staircase.
All right. So you hear more bears upstairs. You hear a ton of feet up there. And you hear what sounds like some of the floor breaking, like they're trying to tear through the floor to get down easier.
God. How
would they tear through the floor with little felt plush?
That's, you know what? Exactly. And that's why it's fun.
They can use weapons. They have little tiny bone claws in there. That's how.
That's level two.
Oh. We don't want them to level up.
Are you inspired, by the way, Josh, by the passing of Wes Craven? Is that what's creating the creepy bears tonight?
No, the creepy bears came in my head last night. As I was lying in bed thinking, what am I going to do that's going to be really creepy? And I looked at when I saw one of the kids' teddy bears, and I'm like,
that's yummy. Yeah. And was that your plan for the whole night?
From last night?
Yeah.
There was
was there any other plan?
Yeah, I got the maps.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Do you guys remember watching Poltergeist? That creepy clown
in
the girl's room?
There's like three movies you don't talk about around Josh. Mm. Okay, Poltergeist. That's one.
Yep. What would his other team be?
I can
Care Bears the movie.
I can talk about Alien now.
Oh.
25 years after I saw it.
And you're not gonna watch it again.
Because I was probably 10 when I saw the facehugger scene. That's amazing. And the belly and the chest buster. That is not a good thing for a 10-year-old to see.
I was about the same age. And I was seeking that out because you know the scene when they're trying to pull the facehugger off and it melts the acid through the floor? That was on the video screen in the movie in the store one day, and I'm like, that looks like a movie I want to watch. I'm like, that must be 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
No.
It wasn't 23,000, but my father rented Alien for me. My father rented me a lot of videos he shouldn't have. Shocker with,
That might have been Wes Craven.
That was Wes Craven.
So, anyway.
I got as far as, like, the movie starts, the guy in an electric chair, he gets electrocuted, the father's reading the last rites over the body, the guy gets up and grabs the creature and throws him through the window. First, like, 5 minutes of the movie, I'm out of the movie.
You should watch the movie.
Yeah, super pants.
I think you're talking about Poltergeist.
You'll laugh.
I don't like
you. You'll laugh.
I don't watch
me. All right, so you make it down here. You hear more scampering in the darkness here. You heard a scream. Probably off to the left a little bit.
Let's make our way hastily.
Hastily? Yeah.
Without regard.
Forthwith?
I'm regarding my haste. Oh, sorry.
You should not.
All right.
All right, so the...
Throw caution.
Right.
The atrium space here, so it goes up to the second floor.
Oh, great. God. It's rain bears.
Sure enough, a couple bears leap off, heading down towards you.
That's your favorite song, right?
Yeah. Okay. We did go down.
We went down into the basement and ended up at the top floor.
Into the belly of the beast. Floor.
Holy cow. Three bears left. They all left at Cochise.
Johnny Boom.
They got a great agility.
I'm kind of imagining the scene from Gremlins where the Gizmo pirate's head in a bandana like Rambo.
One grabs onto your back, Coach East. Do you want to give me an opposed strength check to try to toss it off?
What's that?
Football. Throw him like a football.
A
tight spiral on him, right?
I got three.
And I think he's got like a bow made out of like one of those like.
I'm going to obliterate this thing.
He's just throwing it off your back, dude.
16.
Coach East reaches back behind his head, grabs the head of the bear. The bear won't let go, and Coach East pulls even harder, pulling the head off.
But it doesn't matter, so it's still on your neck.
Aren't you quarterback?
As quickly, I just reached in and pulled the heart out of through it.
He reached back, he grabbed kind of the back.
Put it in your mouth.
Where the neck was, he pulled the whole thing out, was stuffing the handful of the stuffing that came up, brought the heart out with it.
I want to keep one of the hearts, but I'm not going to stop and pick one up. Like, I wonder if we stab a heart, will we, like, bleed?
Maybe if we dress in the bear suit, we can become one of them.
We've seen a lot of bears.
How would you fit?
Oh,
All right. So, you got a lot. There's a lounge area here to the south. To the south, I'm calling it.
Spent 6 years in
opening to another big multi-purpose area.
Learning their ways.
It looks like there's some sort of room over here as well.
I was going to say, is that like the people up the stairs? But it sounds more like Jane Goodall.
That could be there.
I thought I almost heard Holy Honor. Is that Girls in the Mist?
All right, so we're going. Yes.
Girls in the Mist.
Girls in the Mist was a very good one.
Where you guys had
a lot of fun with magic.
Lounge?
Girls in the Mist.
Two loungers. Wow, they lounge a lot.
Dude, this is fraternity.
Which way do we think that the screen came from?
You're guessing probably southwest.
Then I'd say let's go southwest.
Towards the torture room.
Okay, so you're heading down towards this multi-purpose room down here?
Yes.
Yeah.
Torture room.
Sure.
All right, you get it. It's a huge area.
Guys.
Good, I want lots of open space.
I must be so drunk, because I just thought we got attacked by little stuffed bears.
Five more bears attack you in this room.
Like, look right here. Five more? That's crazy.
Deal of cards.
Deal of cards.
Five more bears. Is it any time to throw those cocktails to the people? Or do you want to see a bunch of fuzzy bears attacking us with fire? Should I just do it? What am I holding for?
Burn it down.
Burn it down the house.
I can't see it over this.
Wait till the party's over.
So, bears go last.
Johnny Moon is our first, and then Juan Lowe. Then we have Joe Diffie, Ford Prefect, Edison, and then the bears.
If Ford wants to yell, I'm throwing the Molotov cocktail, and everybody can hold if you want to have that happen.
What do you think, guys?
Yeah.
I'll hold.
Do we have an exit plan?
There,
no.
We're going to burn down the house above us.
You've already burned down one. You've already burned down once. The bears are here.
Let's only burn down the house in the pocket dimension, or will it spread through the whole pocket dimension?
Wait, who's there?
The bears are down here.
We can keep
running. Say it right. The bears are more here.
It's like a shield of a 2-year-old.
No, say it like this. 2-year-old.
All right, I yelled to everybody, make your way to the door. I'm gonna light these
bears
up.
Dub bears
up. All right, so I reach my pack, I take a swig.
It's delicious.
I light it.
Teddy bears.
I light it, and let's have a toss.
Okay, so it's a throwing roll. Do you have a throwing skill?
There's 10 milliliters too little.
You want everything, don't you?
Exactly.
Does persuasion work?
Doesn't quite
no.
Work.
No. Nope, I do not have a throwing skill.
All right, so it's D4 minus 2.
Chris,
minus
Chris,
two.
Try to persuade Josh that you have a throwing roll.
How will you give it to me?
Oh, that's good.
Do you have throwing?
Yeah. Fucking quarterback. Jesus Christ.
At the last second, I go, I'm an idiot.
Actually,
hey, do you ever, you ever throw a football?
Yeah.
You're pretty good. I got something that looks like a football.
Oh, come on, I need a line here. When you throw that ball, I need a line. It better be good.
Mind taking this?
So you make your intelligence just now.
I make my intelligence.
So your action is actually to retrieve the thing and light it, and give it to him.
Really, you should give it to him.
Throw it quickly.
Whose turn is next?
Yeah. Yours, because they're all delaying.
I say, this ain't no long ball.
Come on, I got nothing, man. I'm trying to think of football movies.
Here's my hot ball.
His sister's name is Doris.
I want the ball, coach.
Put me in, coach.
Because winners always want the ball.
You know, they always say I'm on fire.
Coaches.
I hit number 3 in the middle. It explodes out.
Can I get a perfect spiral as it goes through the air?
No,
it actually whips through the air with it.
And over red with the flame. Yeah.
Yeah.
And it looks great.
Bang, hits right dead center of the group. Bottle doesn't break down.
That's
it's
a
hard to break a bottle.
Waste of
yeah, they are.
The bottle
except
shatters.
Except when you don't want to.
Yeah.
No, actually, no. Coach East throws it high. You're like, what the? And it hits the rafter, raining down fire.
Like raining men. That's usually what I.
Hallelujah.
Favorite song. Give me 2d6 for damage.
20d6.
He said 2d6.
You got a Benny in there. Oh, I can't reroll.
And the bear take no damage.
Nope. Okay, all the bears are lit on fire.
And they're still coming after us.
Yeah, and it's starting to smell bad now.
Oh.
It's like burning synthetic
flesh.
So they're melting.
They'll give them 5 seconds, they'll melt. So let's get to the door.
Let's run.
All right, so you're heading to the double doors there on the left?
We're heading to the double doors on the left.
Guys, I swear, wait. Bad news bears.
Is there a door that goes into the same area where there's an open archway? Is that what I'm seeing on there?
This, yeah, I don't know about that. I don't understand that either. Unless that's like a sliding door. Those are,
this one versus that?
Yeah.
I think there's a sliding.
Those like maybe sliders?
Yeah. Maybe those accordion doors?
Yeah, they can open it up for a party. All
right. You run into the storeroom, where you find another trap door heading down.
So many trap doors. How many pocket dimensions are there?
I do notice. I'm going to look all around this room for anything that could possibly be useful. Two.
You find a trap door.
You find a trap door, you find...
I find the door that we came through.
It's really bright out there, guys.
Don't go down there. Shut the door behind us.
I try to lock the door behind us, put something in the way.
How about a broomstick?
There's a broomstick in there.
Oh, nice.
Except there's knobs. Okay. The bears are crawling towards you now.
They can't open it.
You're watching them. It's a sad sight. They're smoking, burning down. They're trying.
Talk about these sad sights are not.
Should I do out?
Sad sights are not fantastically wonderful. Happy time saving our lives.
I go out and help them.
Guys, I think we should put them out.
I go give them hugs. Okay, do you want to do that in front of a bear that's trying to reach up and grab whatever can and choke it?
I can do it.
It's got a warm, soft, fuzzy paw, maybe.
Oh, it's pretty warm.
It's been a while.
It's just like a sheep.
So let's go down the trap door.
All right, you head down.
Guys, what way should we go?
Up. Going down.
All right, we're going down.
That's what she said.
We're going down there.
All right, you come down, and there finally is what you've been searching for. There's 3 sorority girls.
Oh, thank God.
And what?
What are they wearing?
What are they wearing?
Kite sweaters.
Oh.
I attack her.
Wait a minute. We just dealt with some puppets. We don't need sweater puppets.
Bonnie Elliott is lying on a half-burned up bed.
Bonnie's my girl's roommate.
Yes. She's lying on a mattress that was burned and soaked, and she's unconscious.
I'm sure she's on a worse mattress.
The 3 of them are what did I write down?
She's sorry. Now.
That's an upgrade.
That's nothing. It smells better.
They're standing around. And this is weird. There's a 3 of them.
Here's where it gets weird.
they're chanting from a ritual book they have. There's a small bed, like from a dollhouse. Dollhouse size.
Oh, gee, I'm thinking.
On that bed is a lock of hair that matches Bonnie's hair for color.
Making her a bear.
And behind them all, which you can barely see, is an actual dollhouse that models the house they're in.
Oh, good.
The house that you could be running through, not the house that they live in. You've been running through, yes.
Do we recognize these girls?
They look familiar, like you might have seen at the party earlier.
Can we just tackle the girl with the book?
Are they chanting it?
Do whatever you want. Why don't we deal?
All right, so if they're chanting, I'm just going to mumble words. Because you ever try to talk with somebody who's mumbling? And you're trying to concentrate, you lose track of what you're saying.
Stop it, I can't.
All right, here we go.
Wow.
Makes sense.
I only need one.
Okay.
Hey, Bob, why don't you... something above a 4, jerk.
Sorry. Oh, wow. Saints preserved.
They are so enthralled in their ritual, they don't notice your arrival, apparently.
So we have a... 2 kings dealt. It looks like Edison, and then Juan Lowe, and then Johnny Moon, and then Joe Diffie, and then Ford Prefect, and then finally the girls chanting.
The girls. Who's the first you said? You and...
Juan Lowe. Edison and Juan Lowe.
All right.
And then you.
We love going first. Yeah.
Guys. Why was one polar bear attracted to another polar bear? Animal magnetism. I know, but
here. You just deserve
that
it.
That was his turn.
Okay, look at the side. It's unbearable.
I would give you another one, but I just gave you one.
I just...
You gotta spread them out.
can't say them all up like that. I can only give you one bed at a time.
Sorry, it's okay. It was... so we have somebody reading from a ritual.
There's three girls there. They have a ritual book.
Right.
They're chanting from it.
Yep.
What are they wearing?
Tight sweaters.
Tight sweaters.
Anything else?
Jeggings.
Just
jeggings.
Those are like stretch pants jeans.
Jogging.
And okay. Bonnie is reading from a book, or she's
like
Bonnie is unconscious on the bottom. Burned up mattress.
Hey, Edison, you might have a chance.
Sleeping, resting, whatever.
Got it. Okay.
And as they have a miniature bed in front of them.
That's my picture.
The sweet hands.
With a lock of her hair on it.
Both of her.
And the lock of the hair, how is it right directly in their field of view? Is it off the side?
It's your experience with the ritual makes you believe that those parts, the hair and the bed
are the components.
Are part of the ritual, yes. All
right. Guys! I think the hair and the bed are part of a ritual, maybe.
Are you going to do something?
Keep that girl in the head. Or just push her in the head.
She's a girl. I can't do that. That's Edison's going to defer. And
go
next
grab her ritual book for me.
Wine low.
Go grab her. Go distract her.
Wine low.
You know, I was going to say, involving women, any plural noun. I grab her by the rituals. I take care of those books. No, Edison is just gonna. Edison, Wanlow is just gonna run up and like full on tackle the girl with the book.
Okay.
He wants to try and like knock her down, disrupt her, get her to drop.
Just throw a cocktail at her. You don't want one.
Okay,
like,
she.
It's like he's trying to go out for the football team. And he's a linebacker.
Yeah, but she has no idea you're coming. She's
boom,
yeah, you just
crack back.
That's normally what he's used to.
I'm gonna.
All right, give me a...
I'm getting close. I'm surprised you didn't put a roof in.
Give me a damage roll, like strength or something like that.
Oh, there you go.
Greater than a 5, hopefully.
Yay!
Strength, just straight strength?
Strength.
That's a 1d6.
And add it to nothing.
And I will add my weapon, which is nothing. And I get a 2.
All right, you do not knock her unconscious. You knock her down.
Okay.
The ritual gets tossed out of her hands. Bonnie stirs. As they stop chanting.
Edison will race and pick up the ritual book now that it's been knocked out of her hands.
Okay. They do have several candles around for light.
But to burn it.
And I think that's all he can do. His turn is pick up the ritual book. So now it goes to Johnny Moon.
I go and punch the girl closest to me as hard as I can in the face.
Crimes against humanity.
Wow. A face full of...
Wait a minute. Are you punching the pretty one or the ugly one?
Yes.
What is closest to me?
Oh. You know what would be
right now
show?
He's not seeing that.
Fighting roll.
Fighting roll 4.
That's a hit.
What do you have to drop on her?
Is that 2d, 1d6, 2d6?
1d6.
1d6 plus 1d4.
What are you doing?
Strength plus unarmed.
Yeah, 1d6.
Right? My strength is 1d6.
Oh.
5 damage.
She goes down like a ton of bricks. Boom. You might have broke the cheekbone. She's out.
You ain't getting a date.
Next up,
she is going to be coming.
Joe Diffie, there's the one that Jeff leveled. There's the one
both
Juan
girls
Cattle,
are both 80
and there's
pounds
one left.
Knocked out.
I guess I'll take the one that's left.
The sleeping one? What
say,
are we doing? We're fighting.
Say head or go.
You just gonna sock her?
To the moon, Alice.
I'm just gonna drop an elbow on her and knock her out.
Like,
all right.
Like
just walk up behind her.
You
and
gotta
like, super fly.
Gotta give
you
a fighting roll and then a damage roll.
I think what I did was just
fighting roll. You at least a 4.
I got a 4.
Okay,
Jeff. Unfortunately, they were actually trying to save her life, and you just ruined it.
Yeah,
right.
They were taking
the girl. Well, another 4 for damage.
Okay, you know, Mikey levels the other girl. All right, so there's the one that Wanlo tackled is still awake.
Yeah, and I'm on top of her.
Of course you are.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, you heard
her. The other two are out. Bonnie is stirring now, semi-awake, looking around the room a little bit more.
I run up and punch her. Just because.
You're there to rescue her.
Oh, my bad.
Well, we are at college. We're supposed to, like, be, you know, aggressive, sexually aggressive, right? That's what happens at college.
We're just punching all the girls.
Is it all the men are just trying to rape the women? That's just how it is.
Hey, I have 2 daughters. Shut up.
But they're not college yet.
That's not exactly how a college is trying to.
That's not how it works. That's not
well,
how
if you read it,
it
those aren't my reads.
What are you
that?
Doing?
Stay away from
how did you
news.
Get down here? How did you get past my bears?
Well, there
who
was.
Who says this?
The girl at Juan Lowe's.
Would you stop touching me there?
Would you stick something in her mouth?
Edison starts to giggle uncontrollably. You know how you. What happens when you put a bow tie on a bear? You get a boo boo. A boo boo.
Hey
boo boo. Get it?
Hey
boo
boo.
I got a picking egg basket for
boo-boo.
You. We don't usually go out with him.
He doesn't come out much.
Guys, huh?
He doesn't know the liquor well.
The liquor, he didn't even know her. We're on the track, might as well get there.
Yep.
Shut her up, Hank.
No, this is worse. I read Jezebel sometimes. It comes up in
the so you just get. So,
what? Get out of here! You're ruining everything!
Edison looks at the book. What did the ritual seem to see? Was there anything in easily identifiable in the book?
So the ritual, there's not a summary.
No.
But so you're looking through it. It's somehow tied to the house. It actually has something to do with the dollhouse, the bed that they were using, and the lock of hair. And what it actually does, as best you can tell, is it steals the rest from Bonnie and applies it to the girls invoking the ritual, so they don't need to sleep as much. So they can party harder or study more.
Is there any kind of blood instrument that I can crack the dollhouse up with?
Bunch of Molotov cocktail.
Johnny Moon, I think you should take a look at this. I think they're trying to take sleep from her.
That's weird. Maybe they're studying for files.
Yeah, I mean, there's all kinds of debris around. You can pick them up brick probably.
And smash.
You know,
and just smash
back in my day, kids just started riddles.
Did you destroy
it
the little bed, too?
It took less time to try to set up a
the bed
that
they're sleeping in?
Yeah,
no, there's
a
little bed that
the
lock of hair is
going to destroy that.
Yes.
Okay, so Johnny Moon destroys the bed of the lock of hair. Bonnie wakes up. He destroys the house.
Nice.
The little dollhouse.
You're violent.
With brick. You realize as he's doing that, the ritual... It won't work anymore.
Well, you just got to get another lock of hair and another bed and another dollhouse. How hard could that be?
Better magically tanned to work with ritual.
Yeah.
Easy.
Well, that's the ritual on the previous couple pages.
Yeah.
That one's simple. It's a pot, water. All
right, so...
Tells you how to make
tea. I'm going to leave you guys in a more ambiguous spot. What do you do with the girls? You've put an end to the ritual forever at this point.
Bonnie, are you okay?
I think so.
Well, we gotta get out of here.
What about those three?
They're gonna sleep it off down here.
Wow, what happened to her cheek?
She fell.
That's the one that just socked.
We have one who's conscious.
She got a boo. She got a boo boo.
She walked into a wall.
Dude, tie that one up.
We can't. No, well, we got a gag her for one. I think we tie her up.
You gonna ball gag her?
No.
Waldo has that in his pocket.
Waldo, I like some. You're the show so fast.
I think I don't want.
We gotta find a way to tie her. We gotta take a bat. We can't leave him here.
We gotta
bring it to the authorities.
Yeah, we'll bring it to Professor Mack.
Or the police.
Is that
you know?
Well,
what are any of them gonna do?
Professor Mack knows
kidnapping.
How rituals work.
Kidnapping.
She voluntarily went in the house.
Yeah, not in this house. But she wasn't allowed to leave.
We tie him up and drag him by the feet.
Yeah, we're taking him to Professor Mack, who knows about rituals, so he can discipline them.
I'll leave it
with
this. There is ID
with.
In all three.
We tied them up with their own sweaters.
There is an ID.
Yes.
There's ID.
Oh,
they each are carrying it. They're each carrying their sorority ID or school ID with them, so you can find out who exactly they are.
We take it, and I take it and I put it in my.
I take all their.
And your number is.
Can I have your cell phone number?
Hey, Reed, I need five more.
Actually, can we call Professor Mack right now since we have our phone?
We have time.
You're
so
hard
service. Come on, are you kidding me?
They never work.
We
have pockets of
the
services. Pockets of
you have light. You can take pictures.
Is there Wi-Fi? Can we get the house Wi-Fi, which is just 20 feet above us?
No, it's 3 floors down.
Okay, so 60 feet above us.
Listen, my son can't get Wi-Fi. He's one story up. No, I'm kidding.
Actually, you're just in the remains of the house that sank the first time. You've never left the regular dimension.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, good talking about the house sank in I don't think that structurally works, but, you know, whatever.
So we take pictures,
this is
any
video,
anymore.
Ooh, is there a dead bear around that we can take a picture of?
No. There's none in the room you're in.
Is one of them still awake?
The girls?
Yeah, the one who I'm on top of was trying to fight me. Oh,
how did you get them?
And by the way, rock hard. She is so funny.
How did you get the bears to move around?
I think we know who it is.
How did you get those cute little bears to attack people?
Bears answer to any sorority sister.
Really?
Or they did. Now that you've destroyed the house, they're gone forever.
It's Bonnie and Wild. Did you have to do a ritual to make the bears alive?
What's your name there?
The girl you're talking to is Susie Grant. She was a pledge master.
Oh, no, I just wanted
to... You have the ID. So
well, she said that the bears are gone now, so... Joe, go check outside, see if the bears are animate still.
What?
You hugged it.
Take Ford with you.
You're crazy, dude. I'm not going to see that.
We got to go out there eventually anyway. Just poke your head out the door.
I'll go...
Poker. Oh, why did you go up there?
There's like two of you, but I'll go follow. I'll listen to the one the rat says.
Oh, I've got him, but I'm a character this whole time. Edison, go. Just go careful. Go careful out. Look. See if the bears are still walking around.
Shh. I'll go careful.
Edison, you stay here.
I'm going.
Johnny Moon,
going.
You go check for the bears.
I'll go check out the bears.
All right, Johnny Moon climbs up the ladder, flips open the trap door, opens the door. The five bears are cinders spread throughout the floor. They never made it to the door.
Well, they're on fire.
Right. The ones that were pursuing you, you can just see one is just lying on the ground now, face down.
Nice.
Hey, did you ever think that you could animate the bears and then you wouldn't have to hire anybody to clean the house?
We didn't animate the bears. They were here already when we got them.
But
we found it here.
All right, but you ever think you could just clean your house?
They can't leave.
Well, of course, but they're in the house and you can clean their house with it. Like you have a permanent house cleaner.
Cute one, too.
You ever think you have servants? You
can
make your bed,
back call by
do
you
the
guys.
Laundry.
They're not that smart.
Meals.
They're not that smart.
What did you use them for, aside from...
They were here to protect us.
They didn't have a job.
Did they ever protect you?
You're the first one to get down here. This has been going on for a long, long time.
It's the only time they've ever had a chance.
How many people do bears kill?
The bears don't usually kill.
Oh.
What do they usually do?
Usually they suffocate people and then we put them back outside.
And pretend they were drunk.
Oh, and nobody ever hear about this? Nobody ever say they got knocked out by a bear?
Never
mind. I haven't drawn a question.
Does every sorority house have guardian bears?
Not that I know of.
Did you get all really, like, when you joined the sorority 4 years ago, were you like, oh my God, there's guardian bears in my sorority?
Not all the sorority knows about this. Just a few of us.
Wow. But then if
Wait
you...
a minute.
But
girls kept their mouth shut about something?
But I don't understand, because that's a new person. Vaughn is new, and so she knows about it because you brought her down here. So all the new ones must know about it, right?
No, just her. She's the one we've been stealing from.
But aren't you worried she's going to blab and tell
she
you?
She doesn't remember. She didn't... Well, how did you even find us here?
Well...
Why is she asking the questions, guys?
Let's gag
her. Yeah, we owe her nothing.
Tie her hands up behind her back.
Answer her.
Can we? How about guys? Let's get the hell out of here, okay?
Yes.
I don't want to be in this creepy house no more.
Yeah.
We got attacked by fucking bears.
We are monologuing.
Let's dialogue back outside.
Do you guys have other stuffed animals that do your dark bidding?
I'm not talking to him.
All right, fine. We're not gagging him. We take the gag off. But only Edison can talk to us.
Good walking,
lady.
Did you guys ever watch the documentary by the guy from the Flight of the Conchords that is vampires?
What is this Flight of the Conchords? I've heard it mentioned several times.
Thank you, Alan.
There are two people, one of which is the guy who did all the songs for the Muppets, and they're from New Zealand, and they're a comedy hero, and they did stand-up, and then they got their own series. But their stand-up comedy is hysterical, and their songs are phenomenal. You could kill an entire hour listening to their album. Totally recommend it. Flight of the Conchords. We're all on YouTube.
Oh, nice.
But one of them went on to do a documentary on vampires. It assumes three vampires live.
All right, why don't we finish this off and then we go back to
okay,
that?
Okay. Well, you know, we asked the question.
I know.
Here's the lineup of he's just figured out the internet and he's like, I'm doing my doc bidding on eBay. I want that table. And there you go.
Bidding.
Okay, sorry. Please continue.
All right. Well, it's up to you guys what you do. There's two unconscious, and the third one is you, Adam, you know, Wando took out his ball gag, and And one of the carries in his pockets is packed up.
Have you ever considered that what you're doing is very unethical?
Two of us take one girl.
You play with
two
magic.
Two of us take a girl and drag them upstairs.
Yeah.
So there's five of us. So.
All right. So you're taking the girls back out.
Yes.
Scratched.
All right.
Sorry, not done with this yet.
So we take them upstairs.
All right. So you drag them upstairs. You find as you walk by, numerous bears just lying in a heap.
We're taking pictures and video the entire time.
Okay. One falls off the ceiling and lands on Wanlow.
Wanlow, pretend like it's attacking your neck. I'll get it on video.
Here, you ready?
Yeah.
I throw the fucking
bear. Oh, I got a boom boom. Oh, that never gets old.
Oh, before you set it.
All right, you drag up the stairs. Stairs are still treacherous.
There's a ton of bear in a bow tie.
The ladder's going to be a real bubble.
It's fun.
The two you're carrying start to stir a little bit.
These pills are not funny. Literally a bow tie.
The body's able to walk on and off for the most part.
They tell us jokes.
Hey, guys, the girls are stirring. Knock them out.
Well, didn't we tie them up before we slung them over our shoulders?
Yeah, they're stirring. Knock them out again.
No, just let them walk. Why carry them? Jesus.
And then climb the ladder.
Knock them out again.
You can follow the ladder of patients.
All right. My GM, I like this.
You are going to climb back up into their actual sorority house.
Correct.
And granted, it's probably about 4 in the morning now, so nobody's going to be awake, but
still, we don't want them unconscious. Yeah, we'll be like a normal fraternity house of guys dragging women through. All right, we're up there. We let them awaken, arouse, shall I say, a little bit.
All right, so, Bonnie doesn't really recognize what happened. She was, that's why they had to lock her hair. That was a link that was making her come back.
So she
has no idea, which she doesn't recognize any of the place you guys were in. So you climb back up through the ladder to the pantry of the main house.
Make a quick snack.
Is there more alcohol in the kitchen?
No. I knock him out.
Oh. Yeah, there's some alcohol around. It's mostly like, you know, cups with the cigarette butts in them.
Edison's sportively
like a junkie. Anything now.
Reaches for one with the least amount of butts.
I smack it out of his hand.
There's others that you just don't know who or what's in it.
All right.
Could be
beer. It could not be beer.
Makes you think of one of the American pies. Or
I was just thinking, you know, when some other things are yellow for me.
You know, what you did was really wrong.
You know, you're going to let us go and forget about this, or we're going to scream rape. He punched me.
Oh, I'm still recording right now. Should I
you
stop
were,
the
no,
recording?
No, no. Sorry, no.
She
doesn't know that.
These are not the prostitutes you're looking for.
I guess I should stop the recording, buddy.
We keep their wallets and tell them.
No, we just keep the cat. No.
We keep their wallets and tell them.
We cannot keep their wallets.
You have the ritual. You destroy the mechanism for completing the ritual.
And we should take them to the police for kidnapping.
But who's going to press charges?
Do we have a single
one? The girlfriend.
Bonnie doesn't remember any of that.
That's because they kept her drunk the whole time.
I'm getting crazier. I take a picture of their license and tell them if I see or hear about them again, I know where they live.
Well, no, let's call Professor Mack, who knows that rituals are real.
Yes.
And then he's got authority within the university. And we have a cell phone signal because we're in the house now. And we'll call him at 4 in the morning and he'll answer us because we've saved his butt before. And we can, you know, get them kicked out.
Oh, we take them to the police.
This is a great idea.
Well, Professor Mack's going to listen to us, but the police aren't done.
What's Professor Mack going to say?
He's going to say, yeah, they're bad. And then he's going to come up
with... They're bad because they do dark rituals and they worship the devil.
Yeah. And
they're
then...
not worship them.
And then he'll...
Oh, no.
They like them a lot.
Joe Dippy, what do you think?
The rituals, they're all bad. The black magic from the devil.
I'm tired. I just want to go to bed.
Fuck these girls. Oh. Joe doesn't want to ruin any future prospects.
Pretty much. You guys are like, you know... Certainly not going to get laid in college ever again, that's for sure.
Ever again? What does he mean by ever again?
Listen, we knocked some chicks out. That's easy breezy right there.
Kind of a little ethical conundrum what you do.
I think we take them to the police because they kidnapped, what's her name?
Well, we destroyed everything.
They kidnapped her and they kept her drunk and she doesn't remember what happened.
And they've done it to
we
other
stumbled,
generations.
We stumbled
I take my finger out and slit their throats and push it back down the tunnel and say, guys,
It's done. Why are we pissing and moaning?
That's horrible.
And throw him down the trap door. Nobody knows it's there. I cover it with the carpet. And let's move on. Let's just move on and forget this ever happened.
Jay Lorenzo right there.
That's my second. Right, what was the doctor?
For the sake of wrapping this up in a somewhat sane and remotely possible manner, Edison convinces you guys to call Mac. Mac shows up. Because the cops aren't going to listen to you. She has no drugs in her system. You know, it was a magical thing that was bringing her back.
Of course, I'm trying to be ethical by lying.
I know. He said he's not able to get them expelled, but he does get them an academic probation. He gets them kicked out of the sorority.
So, thank you, Professor Mack. You're our hero.
Can I have that ritual then, please, so I can make sure it doesn't fall in the wrong hands again?
No, we have to.
I keep it away from me. I don't want nothing to do with that ritual.
We need to make copies of it.
What?
We already did. We took pictures with our camera phone.
Every page.
All right. And you give the original?
Yeah.
All right.
I'll keep it for my collection.
Bonnie is appreciative, as is Cochise's girlfriend.
I can give Bonnie my number if she has any problems. She can call me.
Missy is very appreciative, too. To Cochise. As a thank you to all you guys, she buys Chinese because she knows you get tired of pizza.
Wait, what is this? What's the kind of racial thing here? You think some Chinese like Chinese food?
I want it for everybody.
I'm just kidding, I think you're cute and I want to make you laugh. Roxanne, I want to keep her away from you.
Roxanne, Roxanne has nothing but great things to say about you.
She's a very lovely girl, so what do you do on Saturday night?
I'm talking
to Missy. I thought I was talking about the girl. Call Chad's
nose. By the way, you're not getting back into that sorority. Don't.
Or maybe any sorority.
Seriously, I think that's just as bad as date rape. You know what she did right there? That was horrible.
Well, I mean,
was there rape there? I didn't see it.
No.
There was something happening without consent.
Stealing her, she was putting her to sleep and stealing her sleep. That's horrible.
Was there anything else going on?
No.
Wow.
What was she wearing on the bed?
The usual toga, half ripped off.
No, just a regular street clothes.
So, guys, what did we learn from our adventure then? What were the learnings of the evening?
That your GM is.
that we don't want to go into a fraternity. Fuck the Greek system.
When you see a bear, do not hug it.
Yeah, perhaps the Greek system is many generations of abuse upon each other. Maybe what we've seen here is a statement on society and the fact that we can form caste systems and use new people when we should all just treat each other like the golden rule, each other like a brother.
Amen.
You want to know what I? You want to know what I learned?
What's that, Joe? Did it?
You talk 10 times more when you drink. So from now on, you're not allowed to drink ever again.
From now on, you only need to smoke weed.
And going forward, Edison, you're only allowed 5 questions per person per day.
But
per day.
But I would be unable to speak after the first 15 minutes of waking up.
That is the entire purpose of that rule.
But Joe Diffy, I had a good time last night. I got my entire passport filled out. Look, I got.
I'm actually proud of him, Joe.
Look at my passport. Look at all the drink stamps I got here. I traveled
Edison,
the world.
Edison, my good friend, the whole idea of last night was not to get all your drink stamps filled out.
Oh.
Get you some company, and I don't mean the fuzzy bear variety.
I had company. I had all you guys. We had a great time. We explored. We got into fights.
Company, Edison. You need some female company.
What would I do with female company?
Talk about math or science or something while you're exploring biology.
Oh. Huh. Well, I don't think I really can talk.
Maybe you could talk about how the population of the world is exploding while experimenting with it.
I guess that's true.
Hey, Bob. Go for your pills.
Oh, thank you. I guess that's true. I never really thought that. You know, I was just thinking, I never stammered once when we were talking to those girls in the sorority last night.
Is it anything to the point you can't talk to girls unless you're drinking?
Hey, Sheldon.
Okay, wait, Raj.
Maybe right. You got something there.
I think we're on to something here, Edison.
All right, Sheldon, we all
spend
set?
More time in sorority house basements.
So ends our session 8.
So ends session 8.
Thank you, Josh.
Stopping recording.